Oh, I probably should have just hold on. Oh wait, no, I can't. If it plays too much of Duel of Fates, this shit'll get claimed. Just ignore that thing in the bottom left there. This is it. Oh, wait, I didn't. Hold on a minute. I'm not using my super sick 4x3 overlay, which is totally wrong. Oh yeah, I set it all up to like be for Mega Man X3 at some point because I was like, I want to play Mega Man X3, and then I just didn't. I was just like, I'll just chill out instead. So let's see. Let's change this. I'm pretty sure I've still got the cover art somewhere. Yeah, there we go. So teeny. So small. Zoop. Oh lord, it's not. Okay, it is. Good. Never mind. God bless giant VHS box sized cover art. That's exactly the right dimensions that I need for this. Let's change up that info box, huh? Alright, well, John Williams, enjoy the money, I guess. Oh. It's a long title. Prequel month never ended. It wasn't a month. It was just, Oh, it's Star Wars Episode 1 : Jedi Power Battles. Well, we can't be mislabeling. Can't be mislabeling games around here. That would be disrespectful to all the sacrifices of the noble Jedi. This is 2000. Wait, Dreamcast. Yeah, it was October 2000. Okay. Wait, no, I wasn't Obi-Wan. I was playing as, yeah, Adi Gallia. Yes, of course. Why did it say level 3? Oh, whoops, because my character was level 3. Crap. What are you playing this on? A Dreamcast. A real Dreamcast. I have an adapter for this controller. Don't worry about that. Don't worry about it. Don't worry. It's a Dreamcast. I think my webcam crop's a little weird now, too. I come back to these ancient times. Blow the dust off of these ancient Jedi texts. Okay, I had. Wait. Huh? Okay, I guess I didn't finish Theed. Never mind. Oh no. There's gonna be the lady. Help! Yeah, I remember this. Help! Alright, let me remember how to play this damn game. Did Dreamcast games come in CD-style jewel cases or DVD-style cases? CD. They were CD jewels in America, at least. That's loud. That is loud. Sorry about that, guys. It's interesting, like, even PlayStation games came in big-ass fat cases at the beginning. Big old books, and then they eventually stopped doing that. Is this the new 3 Mario World Star? I don't know what World Star means, unless you're referring to World Star Hip Hop. And in which case, yes it is. Yeah, I spent the morning massively tricking out Super Mario Sunshine on Dolphin. Because it actually does look pretty good in the Switch port, but I'm not hanging with fucking 30 FPS, no thank you. Okay, I gotta remember my secret Jedi training. I don't remember how to use items. Is it this button? That's jump. That. Probably doesn't matter. Probably cheaper to make the case on the mold of a VHS? Oh! Maybe. They were clamshells, though. They weren't sleeves. Like, most VHS cases had sleeves, but you might be right, yeah. Maybe it was like at the time it was just cheaper to manufacture a tall plastic case than a CD jewel case. Although CD jewel cases were out back then, so I don't know. I don't know. That's what I find fascinating sometimes is when the cost of manufacturing drives like artistic decisions like that, because those are things that often we just never see. or hear about from the consumer side of things. Yeah, superior way to hold a saber, exactly. Every time you, like, you're in the kitchen and you grab, like, a steak knife and then you flip it around so you're a mega assassin. Oh yeah, the jewel cases were hyper brittle. The hinges would snap all the time. Nah, I was never a fan of jewel cases, really. Oh, that's right. You have to, like, hold guard and then hit a button. This is the speedrunning item. Let her go! Oh, it's out. Gotta remember, jump is B in this game. No coin allowed. I don't know, man. When we get to Coruscant, there might be some coin going on. I don't remember what that is. Force. Yes, of course. Oh, yeah! Force abilities. What does that do? I think it, like, sparks enemies that are close to it. This is gonna take a minute. It's gonna take a minute to remember. Oh, okay. It's a Jedi mind trick, which somehow works on robots. It's Jedi EMP. And I think there's timed reflections. I'm remembering all this. It's like riding a bike. My animal was dead. Oh. Yeah, it's Axie, you're right. I mean, comparisons between Witcher and Jedi have been made for a while now. I mean, they're both like knight-errants that roam around and, like, solve problems, right? Turns out the adapting fantasy tropes to science fiction, or I guess in Witcher's case, other fantasy. Pretty common thing. Still too loud? You think? It's on the higher end, but I don't know. It doesn't seem too loud to me. I think it's just that these sound effects are awfully harsh. So I can't really go by the math of it. Okay, I took another little edge off of it. Yeah, those are really piercing sound effects. That's the thing I gotta remember, is you can't mix by math. Sometimes you gotta mix by feeling. Oh no, wait, I ran past these guys. I was pretty sure that enemies do not respawn in this game. Ow. Wawila? Yeah. I am the one in the forces with me or whatever. I am one with the force, there we go. That scene bugged me. That scene really bugged me. Not only because I love Donnie Yen and I thought those characters were actually really cool, but Baze Malbus and Chirrut Imwe. But I was more just like kind of pissed that despite showing faith in the Force and ostensibly channeling it for a little bit, the Force fucked him as soon as his role was done. It's like, all right, we're gonna let you dodge these laser blasts until you flip this switch, and then we're abandoning your ass. Good luck out there, asshole. Immediately gets shot and dies. God, that's brutal, man. I was hoping that Star Wars movies would kind of follow up on that sentiment that the Force is not your friend. And it's certainly, like, through spoken... Oh my god, that's just... Oh. Yeah, the volume mix in this game a little rough. Oh, that was the point of KOTOR 2? That's pretty cool. I think I'll have to check out KOTOR 2. Never actually played it. I started it, and then, you know, good old Obsidian Games was plugging through, like, 15 paragraphs of dialogue in the first hour, and I was like, ugh, there's a lot of reading. Which is weird, because I like games with reading, but I think at the time I was just kind of burnt out on text-heavy RPGs, so I just... Wait, where'd my UI go? I don't know, it doesn't matter. Yeah, I was also not finished. At least at this point there's a, I mean, they do have a, there's like a fan-made completion patch. It's been out for a while. So. You actually read any, like, books? Yeah. Although, I'll be straight. Like, most of my reading comes from video games these days. I'm always reminded of, what is it? Derek. Portrait 2 isn't finished. Does it not have an ending? It does. It's just pretty hastily put together. Oh! Yeah, the UI's gone. That's okay. I didn't need it. I don't know why I didn't have my double jump there, but that's okay. Must have just scraped off the edge or something. Yeah, it's like the ending was really hastily put together. What's up, Chromu? Damn it! Okay. I swear to God, if this version of this game does not play to completion, I will be so pissed off. This game will be basically unfinishable on multiple systems. I've got to like go buy an original PS1 to get this goddamn game to finish. Is that a bark? Where's Jacob when I need him? Almost everyone playing Sunshine or Galaxy? Yeah, I mean, I feel like Sunshine is in that heavily in the nostalgia window right now. Give Galaxy 5 years and it'll be there. Oh, it's a stap. Okay. Stap. Single troop armored platform. Ah. Steal My Sunshine was ahead of its time. Yes, the hit Canadian powerhouse group Len was sonically ahead of the curve. Stop it. I don't know how much health I have. I don't know where it went. It just disappeared. Oh! Ooh. Single troop aerial platform? Ooh. We got a nerd off in chat. Where'd you come from? Len is with the UI in hell. I do like imagining somebody seething about the existence of the group Len. 2000s era, Canadians had a pretty hot time. And I'm mostly just basing on that off of Len and Prozac. I guess the indie rock scene from Canada sort of blew up in the 2010s. Hell yeah, you love Prozac. Prozac fucking rules. I need to follow up with the two dudes. Was it Milo and someone? The other guy didn't. His name wasn't said too much in the songs. I need to follow up with them and see what they're up to. Fucking Rob's Wire's back, baby. Pendulum! But Spotify wouldn't play it. Simon and Milo, that's it. Thank you. They put out they had like a fourth album that wasn't as like electropop, but it was still pretty good. It was a little more down tempo, I think. Saturday People? Maybe that's one of the good ones. I don't remember. Ow! Never played Sunshine or Galaxies. I skipped out on GameCube and Wii, so with takeaways, I don't like Sunshine at all so far, and Galaxy is amazing. Yeah, that's a pretty valid take, I think. People massively didn't like Sunshine because of it seemed to backtrack on a lot of the things that 64 did. Namely, like, it's a little more linear in its level design. The big mechanic around Sunshine is hover. Like, they wanted to figure out a way to mechanically make 3D platforming easier for people. So Sunshine is a little bit less about evolving the form of 3D platformers and trying to make a mechanical platformer that that more people could play. That was the idea. I think they were trying to address the frustration in 64 of, like, going for a jump and just barely missing it over and over because of the camera or perceptive issues or whatever. So if you can put on your little hover pack, then you can kind of wiggle around and make sure you land on whatever platform you want. Ugh, fuck off! Holy shit! Oh! Fucking blind jumps, man. But I gotta admit though, so I got Sunshine all tricked out in Dolphin. I got that HD texture pack, I got that widescreen, I got that 60 FPS. It looks and plays like a dream. Way better than it does on Switch. I bought the pack last night. And I have to admit, like, it's more than just a port. Whoever's been saying that is not entirely correct. There's like there's some up-res assets and touch-ups on like logos and textures and stuff. It could be a lot better though. Oh right, that was the thing that, like halves my health. What was that? Oh, the camera's god-awful and the game doesn't control very well? Yeah.
That's acceptable, I think. Huh. Oh, I guess the curtain must have blown off a spooky witch. All right.
Dino caught you emulating? I just bought it! I bought all of those games for the third, maybe the fourth time. Mario 64. How many times have I bought that fucking game? The first time, DS, again here, bought it virtual console. So yeah, I bought Mario 64 four goddamn times. Nintendo, I'm allowed to emulate it. I'm actually not, but that's where I'm drawing my moral line. If I pay for something, but the community through a hobby can make it look and run better, I'm gonna use that one. But I'm still gonna pay for it. Digital Foundry's video on the pack is a good watch. Yeah, I gotta check that out. I know that. Fuck. Am I just invincible right now? Did I accidentally turn on cheats or something? Because I'm taking a lot of hits. Oh, she looks hurt though. Okay. Yeah, she's hurt. Never mind. It is not legal to emulate. No. Pretty much under no circumstances. I think you can legally own a backup, provided that you have the physical copy and you ripped it yourself. I think those are kind of the... Alright, Nintendo's about to rappel in through my window. But even still, like, that just makes it so you can own the ROM. I don't think emulation is straight up legitimate in any case. So I am kind of doing a very stupid thing by streaming it, but whatever, man. I'll wait for the C&D to arrive if it ever does. I feel like I'm way too small fish for anyone at Nintendo to waste time on it. Oh, okay, never mind. According to all legal precedents, emulation is legal within the United States. However, unauthorized distribution of copywritten code remains illegal, according to both country-specific copyright and international copyright law under the Berne Convention. Okay. So it's illegal to have a website that has the download link on it, but it's not illegal to have or play games via emulation. Fuck, there's another one? What? I can't see due to all this high tech being thrown around right now. Yeah, US law never makes sense. I mean, most law in general doesn't. Process of lawmaking is very weird. Not to mention, like, most laws are made to try and satisfy a ton of groups rather than to solve a problem. Like, we tend to think of laws as like, well, we pass laws to solve problems. Nah. Laws are passed to identify and address problems that people have. Or corporations. Oh. Oh, she's hurt again. Checkpoint, though. Oh, yeah, this is... Wait. I don't think this is the place with the ultimate blind jump. This game's also just way easier if you run past all the enemies, but... What kind of video game experience would that be? You wouldn't get to see these absolutely elite laser reflections. Come on. God damn it. It's legal to play games via emulation. It's a bit iffy on ROMs. Think about it like ripping MP3s off a CD you own, or you bought, versus downloading MP3s off the web. If you own the CD and download the MP3s, it gets even grayer. Yeah. Yeah, I was wrong about emulation pretty clearly, but yeah, my understanding was you can use ROM, like the only way to fully legitimately use ROMs is to rip it yourself, and then hold the ROM as a digital backup of your purchase. Amusingly, it's not legal to do that with DVDs, I don't think. The second you rip a DVD, you've broken the law. Like, the second you transcode or encode a DVD, you're not allowed to do that ever. But who cares about DVDs anymore? It's just like, I just remember like a friend lamenting their DVD collection and that they had kids and they were like, is there some way to legally digitize this? And it's like, no, you just have to get a 100 DVD changer to do it legally, which is just stupid as hell. You would steal a car? Man, I would though. Like, why would you say that? Because I would. Can't wait to download a car. Oh, my UI's back. Great.
I am here to rescue the queen. Can you help me?
I know of a secret passage that will lead us to her. This way.
Yeah, it depends on the car. I'd download the fuck out of a Cybertruck. When you can, like... In the future, like, it'll be pretty easy to get a 3D printer that can just build you a car. I guess all you'd need is the battery, and you can probably just buy a third-party battery and drop it in. Under DMCA, you can legally make a backup copy of pretty much anything you own. DVDs are legal to copy. It's the decryption of the keys used in commercial DVDs that's illegal. Ah, I see. Okay. Huh. I download a house and everything? Yeah. Imagine when you can 3D print a house. I mean, I guess it's there. There are already 3D printed houses. The thing that bums me out about all the things that could happen is that by the way our system is architected, and I'm not saying this is necessarily a bad thing, is that businesses that are in place and operating have momentum and money, and they can use that to stifle any changes to the industry. Oil companies, for example. We could have and should have dropped plastics decades ago, but did not. I mean, they're just fundamentally cheaper, so... There it is. There's that sound we love.
Help!
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 Help! Want to 3D print a girlfriend? You're probably not that far. There's got to be a service where with like custom made or Honey Select or whatever, you can like upload your hentai lady and they can print off a figure for you. Fuck off, man! There, Jesus Christ. That's it. I saved her. She's not saying help anymore. Usually there's like a thank you when you go touch them or something. Anyway, someday soon, you should be able to 3D print Tenga cups. The Tenga lobby's not going to be very happy about that. Although, I worry about that, because then dudes will just beat off into one and throw it away. And then print a fresh one. Where's that reduce, reuse, recycle? Huh? Where is that? Oh, I had to kill everything. Yeah, you're right.
Royal Highness, I am here to escort you to...
Culvrek, thank you for the resub.
My starship in the hangar if we hope to escape.
Filler Bunny, thank you for the prime. Mr. Nutty, thanks for the sub. Chum, thanks for gifting a sub already. You're at it early, I like it. Drastic, thank you for the prime. Oh no! I'll save you, queen! Ow. I will save you, my queen. Is somebody being mean to you on Twitter? I will come to your aid. I do think she can die. I'm pretty sure she can. The railing is blocking the lasers. I really want that thing. Fuck! Jesus, what is that? Yeah! I needed that. Yeah, she had a health bar earlier. I think she still does. This game just has an issue sometimes with 2D things. Oh, I got a life, nice. Don't stand there in front of the fucking Droidica! God damn! What's your problem? What's your problem? Can Droidicas have their shields up while they're shooting lasers? And if so, how come lasers can go through the shield one way but not back through it the other? What's that all about? You guys need to tell me that. Whitney Cummings stand-up. Apparently she did some casual research into the sex doll industry and learned some weird stuff. For example, buyers prefer asymmetric nipples to perfectly mirrored ones. I could see that. Midichlorians, got it. Their gun tips poke out of the shield. Is that the case? That makes sense then. faster refresh, yeah. I could also see something where, like, since they're droids, whenever they fire their guns, the shield could, like, pulse off for a nanosecond while the laser goes through and then turn it back on. But I seem to recall their arms actually reach beyond the shield. I was wondering about that. When I was thinking about it, in my mind, the shield went over their whole frame. But, yeah, you know what? Let's do some research here. Oh! I don't know about that one. I don't know about that. Maybe they push their guns forward through the shield when they fire, because they do kind of do that thing. Yeah, I guess it's just barely out of the shield, maybe, since the shield is curved and the perspective is on this side. I could see that. Yeah, there it's clearly poking out of the shield. Okay. They push forward to shoot? Yeah. All right. Okay. You win this round, George Lucas. I'll get you yet, George. Ow, fuck you! Jesus. All right. George thought of everything. I thought of all this. All this came from my mind. I mean, it's kind of true. Sometimes I wonder, like, for the people who are mean to old George, how much can one person be expected to do, you know? Come up with a whole... Ah! Okay, yeah, I killed her. Come up with a... What? Is this the beginning of the stage? This is the beginning of the stage. No checkpoints. Holy shit! I didn't even... Did I get my life back? I don't think I did. Alright. Yeah, this is a roguelike now. Which means I'm gonna play it like a roguelike. Give me that. Ow! Oh yeah, that's right. Later, losers. Whoa! Force is strong with this one. The force is strong with you. I love that so much. The way he said that, it was like he was eating a really good slice of pie. God, how is Palpatine so good? Have they ever started a Star Wars movie that was completely written by the time fighting has started? Or the filming has started? Sorry. My mind is on the fights. I don't know. I don't know much about the actual, like, logistics and production of Star Wars movies. Yeah, I like how it, not only did it ignore my checkpoint, but I don't think it refilled my health. And it took a life. Like, it would have been one thing if, like, it restarted the stage because it let Amidala die and then, like, didn't give me my health back. But it took a life, too. Did it? Oh, yeah, no, I picked up another life. God, sorry. It's hot in here, so, like, adhesive is failing. There's a little skelly on the wall that just was, like, falling down. Ow. It's extremely haunted around here, you guys. It's extremely haunted. Yeah. I wasn't talking shit. I was actually trying to defend George Lucas. But, sometimes that's the way it goes. He's still gotta strike me down. Strike him down! They always use that phrase. It's never kill. It's always strike down. I guess because usually when Jedi are using that in context, they mean they won't die. It's just killing somebody in anger. So maybe it's not death, and they know that. Killing scares kids. Like, in episode 3, he straight up said killed younglings, right? Couldn't say kids, but he did say the word kill. the Force left you, like you were talking about? Yeah, they become one with the Force, so the striking down aspect, I guess, now that I'm thinking about it, is more about the fact that the Jedi don't die, or Jedi Masters don't die, so if they get stricken down... Ah, I gotta stop picking up that thing. A little red circle. Do it. Revenge was PG-13? Yeah, they've said kill before. And I guess in specifically in the case of Dooku, I don't think he's gonna live on as a Force ghost. Do Sith ever Force ghost? It's only Jedi, right? Jedi Masters? And Darth Plagueis the Wise? Who cheated death itself? Yeah, only Jedi. That's interesting. I wonder why that is. A bit of a bum rap, isn't it? Feels like that's the Force itself being a little choosy about which way is the right way. They can imbue their spirits onto items. Oh, okay. Normal Jedi can become ghosts? Really? It's supposed to be a technique you learn to be a blueberry Force ghost? Huh. Well, that was like, wasn't that the deal with Rise of Skywalker or whatever? Is that Palpatine was sucking up all the Force ghosts? I don't know. I gotta finish watching Clone Wars. I was actually really enjoying that show. Kind of fell off of it a little bit, but... Evermurph, thank you for the sub. It's a Jedi ability for being able to go in the afterlife in order to retain your cohesive self and guide future generations. Since it involves sacrifice, Sith can't do it. Oh, that makes sense. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Qui-Gon had to learn how to do it, but apparently Anakin got the ability for free when Vader died. Yeah? Yeah? Or he figured it out through Palpatine's teachings? Excuse me, Sidious. I do think it's fucking unfair that Anakin got to be a Force ghost. Like, Anakin actually, like, it's actually kind of pisses me off sometimes watching Return of the Jedi now, after knowing what Anakin did and all the shit he pulled off as Vader. It's like, I'm sorry. Like, he did the trick, right? It's like he apologized on his deathbed and everything was cool. Yeah, he's a child killer. He's a genocidal. He tortured his own daughter. Which also, and I know I've brought this up before, but holy fuck, man. When Anakin's like, tell your sister she was right, and then dies, and it's like, I imagine Luke going back to Leia and being like, hey, you know our dad? Remember when he tortured you? Well, he said you were right, so hopefully that's okay. Holy shit, man. I'd be like, fuck that guy! He gets to be a Force ghost now? Fuck him! Oh well. Leia got to float through space, so who won in the end there, I guess. He saved the galaxy, though? Yeah, I guess. I mean, Luke did. Luke kind of teed it up for him. Like, Luke gave Vader 18 million chances, and then Vader finally took one. I wonder about that, though. Like... It was an interesting twist of writing. Like, Luke can't betray his morals by actually attacking or killing Palpatine. But Vader can, because Vader's already bad. But when he does it, it's a sign of redemption. I'm still a little fuzzed out about the morality of Return of the Jedi. Because, like, in the end, someone had to kill Palpatine, right? But Luke couldn't do it because he's a good guy. So what's the real moral of the story? Is that you need somebody who's willing to break the morality rules to like be the fall guy? That's weird. Yeah, it's a moral loophole. I really like the idea of like Luke trying or realizing that violence begets more violence. That's a cool notion, but I think there was no way to write yourself out of that corner. When you have somebody who doesn't play by those rules, you have to have somebody play on their level and kill them.
This way.
They had to come up with for Vader to die and redeem himself. Otherwise, Luke would have been the one to kill him. Yeah. It's a bit it's a bit weak writing, but it is, you know, it's Star Wars, it's fairy tales. I don't really hold it to super high standards because it's not meant to be held to those standards. It doesn't ask to be held to those standards. It's just, it would be, I remember as a kid being like, what, hold on, wait, hold on a minute, what? That's not really pacifist, is it? That's more like letting someone else do the dirty work for you so you can sleep easy at night. I was like, something about that doesn't read right.
Activate security systems.
Help. Help. Just a moral counterstance. Palpatine is trying to corrupt someone specific, so you just gotta get someone else to kill him. Yeah, I guess that's true. Yeah. It's interesting, though, like, like, morality and light tendency in Star Wars is a little fuzzy. But I do remember thinking, like, I mean, Luke, it's okay. You can kill him and then go back to being a nice guy. You don't have to, like, it won't corrupt you, but, I mean, Episode 3 evidences that it does. I think that's the one thing about, that you, if you want to be apologetic in your head, you have to sort of accept that, well, the dark side is, it's always pulling on people, and its draw is unseen and powerful. Yeah, they get up in your face and shoot you with those guns. It's like Batman letting Liam Neeson die in Batman Begins. Yeah, like, I don't have to kill you, but I don't have to save you. And I'm like, well, you're right. It is almost exactly the same. It's a kid film, right? That's why it works.
Follow me.
You try to morally gray it up like Last Jedi and suddenly things fall apart because that's not what it is. Anyway, we don't have to get into Last Jedi. I shouldn't have brought it up. I'm sorry. I apologize in advance. Throne room fight, throne room fight, throne room for that, throne room fight. Man, the prequels were kind of on point now. When you think back on it, you're like, shit, man, they actually were Star Wars. Maybe. I don't know. As time goes by, I do enjoy the prequels more and more. Episode 2 is just the hottest mess, and I love it for that. Episode 3 is solid. Episode 1 has a lot going on. Like, it's actually a pretty smart movie, even if it's told terribly. And that's one of the things I actually do like about it. Bizarrely, it holds up to multiple viewings because you pick up on all these details you didn't the first time. He actually tried... And you know what's so wild, man? Is Episode 4 is kind of like that, too. I always thought Episode 4 was just the dumbest, stupidest, most basic Star Wars movie. Like, it established the formula. But there's a lot going on. There's mentions of the Galactic Senate and all this stuff that doesn't pertain to the events of A New Hope, but just tons of like world-building references all over the place. And I think that's what he was going for with Episode 1, is to just pack it full of these like little one-off references that actually do play into the story that's going to happen. But it was a little too heavy in that regard, it seems like. Let's weed it up and talk about Star Wars. Fuck yeah, dude. Brandon, yes. It's Friday. We're playing some video games, we're hanging out. Let's just fucking annihilate a bowl and talk about fucking Star Wars, man. Laser swords, dude. Oh, I just realized I've never gotten blitzed out of my mind and watched Star Wars. Sometimes I do. Like, if I'm really drunk and I'm just like, I want to see the asteroid sequence in episode 5. I'll say that's one of the beautiful things about modern society and digital media is that you can be that wildly impulsive. You can just bash some shit into your keyboard and within like 15 seconds you're watching the exact part of Empire Strikes Back you want to. Do that for your rewatch of 9? Yeah, I'm waiting for that. I don't know how messed up I'm gonna have to want to watch episode 9 again. I think it is... It's like my self-destruction, I guess. Watching Star Wars on shrooms is the way to go? Ugh. Don't have that one. Don't have that on hand. In the glorious state of California, you can get weed delivered, though. Weed and booze. Just tip-tap on your phone and it shows up. Free market enterprise can do some good things sometimes. Oh, get high and watch Ewok Adventures? That's a good idea. I think I actually did. I think he'd be comfortable with me sharing this, I think. A while ago, Matt Peak hosted a Star Wars Christmas movie party We went and watched the holiday special and the two Ewoks movies. And yeah, busted out the old vaporizer for that one. That was a good ride. Yeah, Life Day special is something else, man. That was a fun time. It was fun to share that with friends the first time. Yeah, they do weed deliveries in Cali. It's sick. It's the best. I was right at the end, too. What a bummer. Now there's these giant green assholes. Bloop, 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 bloop. What are you guys even shooting? Oh, yeah. Coinmeister. Oh. When Grandpa hooks up his fucking Oculus and starts watching VR porn. That's something else, huh? That's something else. It's fun, too, because, like, the Life Day special is when Star Wars is still, like, a heavily 70s property. And it moved into, like, the 80s pretty quickly. But, oh boy. This Star Wars special is magical. A lot of disco in that. Fuck! Off with this shit! Oh! That's it. Luckily, I got a checkpoint, though, so no worries. There we go. That horse shit, man! She died in that hallway. I had to replay the whole goddamn level. And there was a checkpoint right there. Oy. Holy moly. Yeah, when the poison gas hit scans you. Or I just get table flipped. Okay. Jesus! Haha! You're not expecting my Jedi mind tricks! Actually, let me check my combos. I think I got some hot stuff I'm not using. I guess they're grayed out if I... Why does that one only have, like, one of the buttons lit up? YYA? I guess it keeps track of how many times you do them? I don't think I have... Eh. Oh no, I can do them all, I guess. Oh! Cinematic finish. Can't wait for Republic Commando. Yeah, we gotta beat. Oh, fucking Tatooine, man. This level blows. Oh, dude. I forgot about Tatooine. Let's take a brief break and look over the list of prequel games here. I don't remember where it is. 1 minute. Here we go. Okay. Where are we at? Power Battle. So Force Commander, Early Learning Activity Center, Star Wars Math Jabba's Game Galaxy, Star Wars Jar Jar's Journey, and then we kind of get into the more normal games that everyone's more familiar with. There's like four or five educational titles to get through. Episode 1 was just shotgunned with games. Star Wars Demolition, Star Wars Episode 1 Obi-Wan's Adventure, Star Wars Episode 1 Battle for Naboo, Star Wars Starfighter, Star Wars Super Bombad Racing, Star Wars Galactic Battlegrounds, Star Wars Obi-Wan, Star Wars Bounty Hunter, Star Wars Galactic Battlegrounds Clone Campaigns, Star Wars Attack of the Clones, Star Wars The Clone Wars. Wait, where? Oh, we haven't gotten to Clone or Republic Commando yet. Star Wars Racer Revenge, Star Wars Jedi Starfighter, Star Wars The New Droid Army, Star Wars Battlefront. Everyone loves Battlefront. And then Star Wars Republic Commando. So, got a bit. Let me use the restroom and then we get to hang out with Jake Lloyd. See you guys in a minute.
Created an absolutely incredible game.
Oh, wrong button. Hold on a minute. Did I take that button off? Where you at, button? Yeah? There you are. It's in subfolder after subfolder. Stream Deck, man. When you're a meme lord with OBS scenes, you run out of space. Hey.
Huzzle!
Star Wars Demolition isn't really a prequel game. It takes place during Episode 5 and only has some Episode 1 references because marketing. Oh, okay, all right. Well, we can just drop that one then. I didn't do exhaustive research on whether or not all of these games qualify. So, yeah. It's possible that some of these games may be stricken. Eventually invalidated. Let's see here. Yeah, you can't reflect bullets. Which is why... Cade? Wait, what's the bounty hunter's name? That's why he uses bullet guns. And also drop all the games between this and Republic Commando while you're at it. I'm excited to see, what touch-ups the community has done on Republic Commando. Oh, look at all these little assholes. Look at all you little idiots. I'm gonna murder all of you. Every last one of you. Star Wars Obi-Wan is awesome. That's one of the ones I'm really excited to play. I just didn't end up playing a lot of the Star Wars prequel games. I'm not sure why. I think at the time I was still leaning towards PC being my primary gaming platform, and a lot of those just did not come out on that. Yeah. Face when no Republic Commando 2. Yeah, that would be... Why hasn't there been another, like, Star Wars first-person shooter? I guess you could count, like, Jedi Outcast, but that came out a million years ago.
That Joe was stolen hyperdrawing! I'll get him!
Anakin, no!
Oh yeah, Episode 1 Racer has already been played. That was the second Star Wars prequel game. I'm doing them all chronologically, so... First it was Star Wars Episode 1 The Phantom Menace, that... Really funky adventure game. That was a weird ride. And then, yeah, Racer. Which is unfortunate, because I think so far Episode 1 Racer has been the best Star Wars prequel game. God, that game's so good. Gonna take a crack at Jedi Academy. That is not a prequel game. Unfortunately. No KOTOR, also unfortunately not a prequel game. The gimmick is supposed to be just games focused or set in the prequels. Which does exclude a lot of very good games and include a lot of very bad ones. That's kind of the point, though. I'm trying to dive into all this weird crap that nobody probably actually played. The kid-focused, like, educational games are a trip. There's some good music in them, and some, like, weird, questionable, I guess more just like, I guess this would entertain a kid for an hour or two? Really? Pit Droids was pretty interesting. I think that's the challenge icon, so I'm not gonna grab that. I don't need the hot points, really. No, wait, what am I saying? Oh, I can't go back! I forgot the ninja mentality for a second. On technicalities, isn't Fallen Order a prequel game? No, because it's post Episode 3. It has to be like... Ideally movie related, but I guess the prequel window ends when Episode 3 the movie ends. It starts at the beginning of Episode 1. What the hell is this? And ends at the end of Episode 3. What the fuck? Weird. Maybe this is like a Dreamcast exclusive sequence, because they can have that many enemies on screen. Yeah, that's smart item use right there. I feel like I did Ninja Proud there. Look at him, there goes Anakin! You're gonna blow up an entire planet later! Millions dead! Billions, even. Can't wait for him to slash some younglings. That sequence was fantastic, though. Like, the off-screen action of that sequence, so great. It makes it horrible, but it doesn't rub your nose in it more than it needs to. I've been thinking a lot about nose rubbing since finishing Last of Us. Stream with Jacob, like he and John do with Souls Boys. Background commentary and Oracle powers would be fun to watch. I mean, sure. Jacob has a life too, though, so... I don't want to, like, try and push people into doing too much stuff. Jacob still has a full-time day job. And he's dedicated his Wednesdays to doing stuff with John, so... I'm fairly certain, well, I guess I can't be certain, but I'm pretty sure at 1:45 p.m. on a Friday it would be unlikely that Jacob would be free to sit here and yell at me playing Star Wars games. Where do you get all that vintage footage before your stream? A lot of different places. A lot of it is just on YouTube, really, but archive.org is a pretty good spot for it. I have made connections with somebody that digitizes VHS tapes, so I've been pulling some clips from their work. I worked out a deal where I pay them like $200 a month for a licensing, so I can just pull the clips that they yank off of old VHS tapes. It's an interesting underground community of people that like VHS hunting is a real thing. People go to like pawn shops and there's like conventions for people to show off the weird tapes that they found. There's a lot of VHS was a pretty great technology because kind of like YouTube, it allowed a bunch of people to commit to and immortalize whatever weird ideas they had. So home movies, exercise tapes, like it really is just a micro version of YouTube. And you can find some amazingly dated stuff in there. What's the legality of that? It's kind of not an issue because a lot of these tapes nobody owns the rights to anymore. Or if they do, they don't know that they do. So it's just kind of all considered abandoned material. Like there's no one out there who's going to like pursue some like Christian yoga VHS tape from 1985, you know? Nobody even remembers doing that, much less being pissed off that it's being yeah, thank you, boss. Yeah, Forgotten_VCR is the Twitch channel. They do the dude in question does like VHS mashups and we'll play them two nights a week, maybe three. But yeah, you can catch those mashups on twitch.tv/forgotten_VCR. They're a good time, man. If you like weird old stuff and just seeing strange things, he is a little more intentional with his editing. He'll thank you, boss. Yeah, it's in chat there. But he'll edit clips together to kind of create a narrative, and then the cool thing that he does is he'll watch chat sort of come up with narratives around the clips and the characters in them, and then he'll edit the next one to lean into that narrative. So it is this sort of like back and forth creative process, which is really neat. I on the other hand, I take a bit of a different approach. I edit clips so that the timing implies either meaning before or after whatever that clip is, but I also don't programmatically edit any of MediaTek. It's all randomly played. So I'm always fascinated in our abilities to find patterns and meaning behind things that may not have patterns or meanings. So for me, I like the fact that it's randomized at its core. It is, to a degree, like this is also me experimenting with very rudimentary, like almost like it's not even artificial intelligence. It's just a random seed from whatever it grabs from my CPU. But I do like the idea of programmatically generated content. And programmatically generated meaning and context is really fascinating to me too, and that's very much the microcosm of how I play with those ideas. If I were more avant-garde and didn't like playing video games all day, I'd probably lean into that a lot more with different media projects. But as it stands, I want to spend, you know, 12 hours a day playing old video games instead of experimenting in lost media space. Never watched the edited R-rated prequel Star Wars video? No, what the hell's that? Did they just edit in a bunch of adult shit into episode one, or? Oh, you enjoy it? Right on, Sino. Yeah, actually, if you like that, then you should hang around tonight. Every Friday. Here, let me click on this. Click on this link right here. Nice. Corridor Deaths Made Gory. Okay, wow. I'll check it out. Yeah, every Friday I do what I call Media Tech, which is really just a ripoff of GeForce Cinema Tech. That's where I just let clips kind of play for a few hours. So if you just want to chill out. Maybe if you're still under the effects of the aforementioned bowl, it might agree with your mental state. I think this one will be PlayStation themed. Since we're in PS5 territory now. I tag all the clips with metadata so that I can selectively make playlists according to certain themes. So everything and anything PlayStation, I think, is what I'll do tonight. Which the connection there can be a little tenuous, but it is what it is. You gonna check out Squadrons? Yeah, absolutely. I'm excited for that game. And since, man, I still haven't streamed Microsoft Flight Simulator, but I got that hardware, and I have a VR helmet, so I might be able to enter maximum immersion mode. I feel like using a stick and a yoke and a throttle, like all that stuff is probably just going to be way slower and less competitive than just using a keyboard or buttons, using a controller. So it might just be like, campaign is immersion. Once you go online, you gotta use a controller. I was not able to get a 3080, no, or a PS5. I probably could have forced a pre-order through for a disc PS5, but that's gross. The PS5 is already ugly. I don't need it to have a little flat tire on the side. But yeah, no 3080 for old Lawrence. There's another problem beyond not getting a 3080, is that those cars are too fucking big. They're too long for my case. I have about 11 and a half inches of clearance for video cards in my case. And that, like, I only found one and only one 3080 that is short enough to fit in my case at all. So either I'm gonna have to, like, get into my case and, like, start grinding out drive bays, because I don't need them. Like, there's, like, 5 1/4 drive bays in there that are just taking up space, but yeah, I might have to get in there with, like, a Dremel or, I have a drill bit and, like, a diamond cutter. I might be able to chop some of that out, and it would make the case lighter and give me more space. Like, I don't need any of that crap, but yeah, the 3090s, I worry. Yeah, I have a Dremel. I've used it plenty. So as long as the, like, weld points are really tiny, and I think it's welded, it, like, doesn't wiggle at all, the drive bay. So as long as it's just, like, spot welded in some spots, I can just grind that off and pull it out. Probably better to buy a new case. I don't know. I'm a fan of trying to adapt existing hardware. I guess object permanence is not what it's called, but that's how I interpret it. I would rather spend an hour yanking pieces out of my computer than just buying something new. I don't like throwing stuff out. It's less about hoarding or the guilt of throwing things away, and more about, I don't know, if there's something I've used for a long time, I get a little attached to it and I'd like to continue using it. Yeah, sentimental value is, I guess, what it is. Also, part of me doesn't like how impermanent everything is. I'd like something to last a little while. Oh yeah, this boy is a mini boss, actually. I love tossing things, minimalism. You can be minimal and like, I do love throwing things away too, but like, once you throw everything away. Ow. Like, this wouldn't be throwing something away, it would be throwing it away and replacing it, which to me isn't minimalism. To me, the true minimalism is not throwing it away in the first place, not buying a new thing that you theoretically don't need. I actually don't know what minimalism is. I'm using that word. I'm a big fan of reducing complexity. Partially that's my engineering mentality, I think, but yeah, I remember he rolls. Jesus Christ. Simplification, yeah. Cut off all my friendship ties because of my alcoholism. Why is this not a good thing? So wait a minute. You're an alcoholic. So you broke ties with all your friends so that you can continue drinking? And you want me to explain to you why that's a good thing for you? Because I'm not going to do that. Or perhaps you're being jokey. You're having a laugh, which is fine too. If you're minimalist, surely you wouldn't buy something unless you need it. Yeah. I guess that's my approach, is I always try to find if I can solve a problem or a need with what I have. God damn it, dude! With what I have, rather than investing in something new that I'm not sure that I need. I don't know that his health bar is going down at all. So he does this crap. Ah! Oh, there we go. Maybe a modest yet practical hoarder? I guess people have different definitions on practicality, but that works for me. Wants to joke about my bad takes? Okay. To me, that's how I express my sentiments of counterculture. I feel like everything in America is disposable. Consumption is considered like a lifestyle. So I try to push back on that by being like, no, like I'm not just gonna buy a new case just because it's cheap and it's on Newegg or whatever. I have the case, it works well. I just need to figure out how to adapt it to keep it working well, that's all. I would rather throw out a 5 1/4 drive bay that I've ground out of my PC case than an entire PC case that I've used for over a decade. I know Lawrence and Funnest was an overact, but you've dealt with alcoholism, right? I wouldn't say that I was ever a full-blown alcoholic. I do know one specific time when I started to feel the tug. Like I had a drink and felt an overwhelming compulsion to have more, even though it was like it was in the middle of the afternoon and no one else was drinking. And that's when I was like, ah, that there it is. That's it. That's the feeling. And if I had just sort of obeyed that feeling, it probably would have led me into more and more drinking. But that's kind of when I was like, alright, it's time to... When I feel this is exactly when I need to not drink. So, I didn't drink then, and that's when I was kind of like, okay, I found my limit, I guess. And then, you know, as the years went by and I sort of inefficiently processed whatever trauma I was dealing with, I tapered that off more and more. It was a coping mechanism, and a fun one, for a while, but not an efficient one, nor a healthy one. That's what an alcoholic would say? I guess you're right. Well, here I am, not drinking, so... Something must have worked out for the better. I haven't had a drink in a long time, now that I think about it. Which, like... Oh my god, you guys. Alright. I wanna set the stage properly. I'm sitting here in a Doom chair that's awesome that I got for free. I'm playing an old game that I'm emulating, but I did buy it. I did buy it for whatever that counts. I'm using a controller that's also amazing that Microsoft sent me. I want to say these things so that when I say what I'm about to say, it's going to sound even worse, all right? Voodoo Ranger has been sending me beer, and it's good beer, like it's delicious, but I'm trying to lose weight. So I just have like all this beer stacking up in my cabinet, and I would give it away, but it's heavy, and it costs a lot to ship. So I'm kind of stuck. Like, I don't have friends that drink beer. Stephanie doesn't drink beer. I love beer, but I'm trying not to drink it because I don't want to get fat. I'm trying to do the opposite, so I'm like... In addition to all of the wonderful free things I enjoy, I also have just all this beer. All this free beer! Yeah, I don't know. Is it... I feel bad saying don't send it to me, because doesn't that seem a little like, hey, thanks for all the free shit, but stop it. I don't know. Maybe? It's just, give it to the homeless? Yeah, maybe I could do that? We got some fine folk in the neighborhood that would probably enjoy that. Why do they send you the beer? Because I was talking to them, like, they have an influencer program and they send stuff to people. Wizards! Send it to viewers? I just brought that up. Like, it's expensive and heavy and shipping alcohol. Oh, right. Yeah, this thing. Ooh. Man, Maul does not fuck around. You're not, you can't actually beat him. You just have to stay alive for long enough. But you can get points off of him if you, Oh, my trick doesn't work! Just keep it till your New Year's Eve party? That's a good idea. That's the other thing, like, with quarantine, I can't, like, invite people over and give them the beer either! I can't! I'm out of options here. Wrap the beer in a manger, leave it on the doorstep of your local church. Away in a manger, no mouth for this beer. Give them a beer, but stay 6 feet away. Yeah, just like fire it like a... Give a sweet spiral football pass. I suggest that you can drink 1 to 2 beers per day. So that's like 500 extra calories. And no, I cannot. No. That article suggests you can have 1 to 2 beers a day as moderate drinking, not as something you could do as a healthy lifestyle. Yeah, moderation is defined by most doctors as 1 to 2 beers per day. That doesn't really mean that you can do that and still work out. Or it's like you can't burn off all those calories, really. Oh, sick new combo. Sick, sick, sick. Always more health. Oh, wait. I don't know which one I was... I don't actually know which one I picked. Well, whatever. It doesn't matter. Well, the LA Kings Cup. Yeah, I got that in an LA Kings game. Ah, Coruscant. Sweet, sweet Coruscant. We're back. I feel like... Did they change the levels? Because Tatooine had like a horrifically long platforming sequence with a ton of like probe droids and stuff, and I don't remember that necessarily being in that version of the level. I think this game might have some gameplay balance tweaks with the levels. Because I feel like, No, that was Theed. We'll see. This is the level I remember the most. Because I had to play through it 1 million times. Oh, I guess it's not that car yet. I think the Dreamcast version was made easier. I think you're right, which is unfortunate. I'm not playing the real version of the game. Ninja would be so disappointed. Whatever, he doesn't play single-player games. Fight Maul again, I assume? Oh, yeah, I assume. Gotta be at the end. Yeah, no, the PS1 version is brutally difficult. Why can't I use the item? Oh, maybe you can't. Oh, okay. You can't while you have force power out. Down 30 pounds, getting tired of 1,200 to 1,500 calories a day. That's what I'm on. I'm trying to do 1,500, and yeah, you get exhausted of it after a while, but you gotta turn your brain off. Just gotta be like, this is it. This is what I get. Just think about something else besides food. For me, like video games and caffeine help a lot. If I have a good amount of caffeine in my system and I'm playing a sweet video game, I can forget about hunger for an hour or two, which is usually enough to get me to like another snack or another meal, and then it's kind of back to the same thing. 1500 is easy until Coworker says, hey, let's order a pizza. It's not easy for me. I have to like, I gotta be pretty rigid. All of my calories have to matter, you know? If I'm eating 1500 a day, they all have to be like protein, they all have to be fat, they all have to be nutrition. There's no room for, like, just empty carbs in there. Otherwise, I just kind of crash pretty badly. But if I eat good, nutritious food and have a lot of vegetables to sort of fill my stomach, 1500 is survivable. Evermurph, that may work for you. It definitely does not work for me. I would also advise against telling people not to do things, especially if they are working for them, so. Just cut out the carbs. I can't tell you how. No offense, Murph, and I'm not mad at you or anything, but I am so annoyed at people who are just like, oh, I just stopped drinking soda and I lost 50 pounds. And I'm like, great. Great. What pisses me off is, like, some people do that and then they just assume it's that easy for everybody else. Man, I stopped drinking soda and nothing changed. Nothing. I've had to, like, I have to stop, like, I'm at the point where I just basically can't eat bread. I can have one slice of bread a day, maybe, and that's if it's, like, whole grain. Like, granted, I'm in my late 30s, so it gets harder and harder, but, yeah. I want to be very clear, man. You did nothing wrong, and I sometimes I feel bad setting up the tone that you did anything wrong, because you absolutely didn't, but it's just a sore spot for me. Sometimes people get very, very dismissive for me. Or, sorry, get very dismissive about, like, how difficult or different it can be for people to find a path to fitness and weight loss. But also, yeah, I mean, soda sucks. Did you drink a lot of soda to begin with? I did when I was in high school and college, yeah. And then, I got so big in college, I was like, this is gross and I hate myself, so let's try to address the problem. And then that's kind of when low carb was kind of becoming a thing, so just as an experiment, I was like, I'm gonna just cut out all sugar. All sugar. No sweets, no soda. I did that for a month and didn't really feel any different, but a month is not enough time. I didn't know that at the time. I just had basically no concept of health or nutrition, so I had to kind of find it myself through trial and error, which takes way too long. Especially, yeah, this is the real fun part. This is real Jedi Power Battles hours. So, yeah. Swoosh. I mean, what really worked for me basically is kind of doing the keto thing, because keto is kind of easy to explain to people, and it was easy to wrap my head around, and I just didn't think about or know about calorie counting at the time. So I switched to most of my diets being, or most of my meals being, like, because I was a college kid, you know those, like, sacks of, uh-oh, sound effects are starting to fuck up again. Are you serious? Are you serious? This is not happening, I swear to God. You know those, like, at Walmart, you can get those, like, giant pre-cooked sacks of frozen chicken breasts? Most of my meals were a chicken breast and then, like, a salad or whatever other vegetables I had. And that's when I started losing weight, shockingly, because I was eating just chicken and vegetables all day. Yeah, Leon. Exact same boat. It's insane how hard it is for me to lose weight. I've been stuck at 230 for a while now. I just want to get down to 198. Yeah, I mean, what is working for me, although it is difficult to make it utterly sustainable, is just heavy calorie cutting. It's not playing the music. Uh-oh. The sound lines aren't working either. Uh-oh. Is this game really this scuffed? It's just gonna freeze up? Well, so the other version of the game did, like, do I have to jump back? Oh, no, wait, you have to kill these guys, that's right. I suck at not snacking at night. I can be fine for a week, then it starts to happen again. Yeah, that can be rough. This rarely works for me, but a common tip I've heard is to drink a lot of water. If you feel hunger pangs when you're trying to go to sleep, sometimes loading your belly up with water can like, at least make you feel a little satisfied for about 20 minutes or so. I've had limited success with that. God, there's no sound. The other aspect is to just have, and this is not fun, but to have, like, zero calorie or low calorie snacks. So I know it's not tempting to eat a giant wad of spinach right before you go to sleep, but if you season it right, and if you're actually hungry, that will take care of that. Evermurph, thanks for gifting 5 subs, dude. I appreciate that. There's a particular dynamic that I've seen happen a couple times, which I'm not super fond of, and I've been trying to get better about it, but, like, if I express any negativity towards someone in chat, it can sort of invite this sort of gang up thing to happen, and I feel really bad when that stuff starts to happen, so I gotta be very careful with my tone sometimes. Miss me being on Funhouse? Yeah! I miss working with my friends, but, life goes on. Oh no. Ow. Oh, whoa! Checkpoint. Stevens, you need your ego taken down a peg? I'm gonna let someone else do that. I'm gonna let someone else have that joy. Yeah. I love where you are. Ferris Bula, man, me too. Me too. I'm having the time of my life. I'm excited because not only have I got to do this for months and months and months, but maybe, just maybe, some of the other things I was going to start doing in 2020 might be coming around too. Maybe enough time has passed. Just have a call about that potential in a while. Oh yeah, you got to kill all these dudes before the car shows up. There it is. Never mind. Yeah, my OnlyFans account. Nah. Why do you think I'm trying to diet so hard? I know if you want to make that OnlyFans money, you gotta have those abs. Gotta get all the thirsty mans and ladies and everything else grabbing their mom's credit cards and throwing me money. What's your most hyped game from the PlayStation Showcase? Oh, Demon's Souls, for sure. I mean, I would say Demon's Souls is probably the only game I'm hyped for. Ratchet & Clank looks really fun, and I love Insomniac, so I'm not worried about that at all. I think that'll be really fun, but really just Demon's Souls. Demon's Souls is like the first game I've seen that's like, okay, this looks like something that can't happen yet. Yeah, actually, yeah, that's a good point, Flav. Final Fantasy 16, I keep forgetting about it, and I don't know why. It's actually really exciting that there is another numbered Final Fantasy coming. It looks like it's more in line with what I like from the series, which is sort of dark, character-driven fantasy, maybe more political plot lines. A lot of people were commenting that this looks like a Matsuno game, like it looks like Vagrant Story or Final Fantasy XII, and I am super down with that. With the exception of Shadowbringers, which kind of had that vibe, and Stormblood, for that matter, for Final Fantasy XIV. 15 had dashes of it, like... That storyline was in 15, but it wasn't in the game that you played, weirdly. Yeah, I don't know what Five Nights is going to be about. Like, the thing was, it was mostly concept trailers. If there was more gameplay, then I might be more excited about different games, but as it stands. I mean, Demon's Souls was ostensibly just like 4 minutes of straight gameplay, and it all looked awesome. And granted, it was fudged a little. Right, forgot about that guy. 16 is so far out, though. The demo not being on the console? I don't know about that. I think we can have faith in Yoshi P right now. I mean, he's demonstrated more than once that he is a closer. Like, he gets products shipped, and Square needs somebody like that. Square needs a producer like that. They have for years. So, I have a lot of faith that Yoshi P's on it, but also Square chose Yoshi P to be on it. So... That means I think Square identifies they need to fucking ship games. They need to finish and ship games. More than anything is like, I don't need 16 to be a home run. I'm just glad that we can look forward to maybe an increased pace of game shipments from Square. So it's like, even if 16's not a smash hit, 17 might be 3 or 4 years after that. And that's like, please go back to your PlayStation 1 pace. And I know that that's a silly thing to ask given how much more expensive games are to make and how much more coordination they require, but if we could get a numbered Final Fantasy like every 3 or 4 years, that'd be fantastic. Yeah, people need to stop putting a number on things. I mean, he definitely waved a magic wand on Kingdom Hearts. That became a whole phenomenon. It became a brand. And I think that was the business mode for Square for a while, is if we put a number on things, he'll convert them into big brands again. And then not only do we get game sales, but we get toys, we get merch, we get licensing, we get all this stuff. Whereas Yoshi P is like, maybe we should make games and worry about all the rest of that stuff later. What a save! What an accidental save. Yeah, this item is kind of custom tuned for the sequence. Peace out, losers. They did manage 4 Final Fantasy games in 4 years, didn't they? What, you mean like back in the day? Or... Yeah, 15 was an engine hell. Yeah, I mean, that's another part of Square's internal culture that may be shifting, is that they found a lot of success and prided themselves on developing their own tech and then developing the games that ran on that tech. I mean, Final Fantasy VII really was the advent of that. They, you can actually catch it in the BRB reel that I show. There's an interview with, is it Sakaguchi? Where he was basically saying, like, Final Fantasy VII existed because they did a demo at SIGGRAPH of animating 3D characters over streaming video. And that's the reason they went with PlayStation, is because they had that technology, they had that engine available. And it paid off dividends, man. Some of the interactive sequences at the beginning of 7 are so incredible looking, comparatively, that it really made it pop for people. Being like, having the camera swivel around behind Cloud and then run into the reactor, amazing moment. Like one of those tech explosion moments. It's tech that enabled that to happen. So I think Square was running with that culture for a long time, developing Crystal Tools and what is it, Igni's Regret or whatever, that tech demo they put out in like 2012. They were trying to follow that path of like, our success came from us making, you know, industry advancing technology and then building the games on top of that. But time has moved on, man. Just use Unreal. Yeah, you're going to start getting diminishing returns on all that. And if your competitors are using middleware and you're making it all yourself, you're inheriting a lot of cost and time that they get to skip. So it's really like, it's less about what has given you success in the past and being competitive with companies in the future. I feel like I won't bring it up. There are many companies, some of which I have worked for, that have followed similar paths of like, they found success in the marketplace by creating their own tech or their own platforms. And then they try to keep doing it well after that strategy doesn't seem to work anymore. But you, ultimately, I feel like you can't question the business sense of like, this is what worked for us in the past and this is where our culture is, so why would we change it? Just because everyone else is doing it. So I get that. But I think for Square and for a lot of Japanese companies, that was kind of, that really hurt a lot of them, a lot. Like Konami and Capcom, they kind of all had that mentality too. Capcom got out of it, thank God, because Capcom still makes pretty good games. What about the Rage Engine for Rockstar? Yeah, so there are a few examples of that still working, right? The Rage Engine is a really good one. Rockstar has found a way. I mean, and CD Projekt makes their own engine too. So I think the difference is that those companies have, like, I guess Rockstar didn't, but their games sold so well. They just had a bed of money that they could sit on to work from it from. Yeah, Dr. Levin, and I'm like, that's mostly what I'm referencing to when talking about Yoshi, is, yeah, well, you said in the NoClip doc for 14, Yoshida basically said before he came into the project, his opinion was Square got complacent and arrogant about how good they were at making games. They had the best quality up until then, so they feel like they can just kind of remake 11 and not innovate and like what other MMOs were doing. Yeah, it's crazy. Hold on a second. This is such a dumb aside, but I'm gonna see if maybe it's just in Drive. Maybe I just saved it in Drive. Let me see if I can find my Final Fantasy 14 review from way back in the day. Let's see. Where did I keep it? I think it's packed away inside of a database for the old Inside Gaming website, which I still have and still have set up. If I can just run Xamp. Oh yeah, that's right. I have to find the console exe. Is it this one? Yeah. Start Apache. MySQL's already running. Good shit. K Can I connect to localhost? Let's find out. Or maybe I'm not. 127. I'm not gonna give you my sick IP. Oh no, it's working. Okay. Sort of. I feel like it's only half loading, which is a... Yep. Let's see if search works. I remember I had to tweak something about it. Jeez. Let's see. Because the only reason I bring it up is, preview. Oh, Realm Reborn preview. Realm Reborn. I reviewed a Realm Reborn? I don't remember that. I know that I reviewed 14's initial launch, but that would have been... Yeah, it would have been about 2010. There we go. Okay. It's funny to bring that up specifically. Oh, yeah, I think I unlisted all of these videos. Oh, never mind. I guess... Huh. Wait, what? Oh, they redirected it. I'm going to have to change these links. I think I wrote out different like review guides for each portion of the game. Yeah, I did. And then I embedded YouTube videos from it. And tried to like chronicle it as much as possible. Man, this is like... Oh, hey, some of them are still there. Yeah! I was like reviewing an MMO is really ridiculous. So how can I do this in any kind of way? So I basically broke out the review into multiple parts and then would record video samples of them all. I did a lot of work. Shit, man. Yeah, this was like 10 years ago. I remember somewhere in here reviewing that, like, this game seems like it was made ignoring World of Warcraft and every other thing that happened. 2014 Lawrence. No, this is 2010 Lawrence. Yeah. This is 10 years ago. This is like when people talk about streaming and stuff, I'm like this was the work I was doing when no one cared and no one was paying attention and no one knew who I was. This is the amount of over-delivering I did to try and create a reputation for myself. Let's see here. Final Fantasy XIV is in no way a game for everyone. It's not even a game for some. Final Fantasy XIV is a game for few. Simply playing the game must be its own reward because you won't get any others. If you enjoy immersing yourself in incredibly complicated game systems and reaping benefits earned from hours of research, XIV is your game, sort of like Demon's Souls. I don't know, that's a weird comparison. Should have borne that out a little more. If you instead want an experience that properly educates you and provides incentives and rewards for your continued play, just wait for World of Warcraft Cataclysm. I remember there was some bit in there about... just analyzing the game itself and being like, there's nothing here. This is weird to read 10 years on? A little bit, yeah. But yeah, I like broke all these sections out and then wrote a summary of all of them. Guild leaves are the only progression structure to the game. You can accept the leave that will set combat, item creation, and resource gathering goals. Once you meet them, you get a gold bonus. Some of these activities, you'll have to set your own short and long-term goals. Because, like, even just the UI was really raunchy. God damn it. Fucking... Why? There's a redirect. Damn it. There's a redirect somewhere that just bumps InsideGamingDaily.com to the YouTube page. And it was set a million years ago. That's weird. Why is it just... Why does it have issues now? Yeah, whatever. I remember working on this and then going to tutor high school students to try and bring in some extra money in the evening. Streaming is a full-time job now? Sorta, yeah. I would say that's where most of my revenue comes from. I have other things that I do and work on that are not as visible as streaming. Some of them I'm not really allowed to like take credit for various reasons that years from now I'll probably be able to say why. What happened to 15 Online? It released. It was called Comrades or Brothers or something like that. Yeah, there was totally a co-op Final Fantasy 15 thing that was actually pretty fun. Whoa, that dude flipped me right off. Comrades, that was it, yeah. It's not an NDA, Borden. has nothing to do with NDAs or paperwork. Just, discretion. That's really it. Sometimes in this world, you can make life simpler for people that you- UGH! This dude keeps wanting to uppercut me off the goddamn ledge. You can make life simpler for people that you want to make life simpler for by just not saying things sometimes. What did you teach the young children? Let's see here. Some of it was high school, some of it was college. A lot of people needed help with calculus, because of course they did. The better tutoring sessions I had were with high school kids, because it's just an easier subject to tutor. One of the things that would be wild to me is, like, if you tutored college kids, they've already done some of the work. Like, they got into it, and they know exactly what they're doing most of the time, and they just have trouble with this one problem that also happens to be the hardest problem of all. So you get there, and you're like, oh, calculus. And they're like, yeah, I'm having trouble with this one problem, and they show you, like, a page full of notes, and they're like, well, so what's the deal? And you're just like, all right, well, first of all, I need to remember calculus. So, yeah. It was intimidating, man. Trying to show up and help people with stuff, and then they would just dump the biggest problem on you and then stare at you while you're like, I don't quite know where I'm at yet. Feeling like they were judging your worth as a tutor or gonna leave a bad review. There was one guy who just straight up wanted me to do his homework for him. And I'm like, well, I'm not gonna do that. And then he got kind of pissed off and he's like, what am I paying you for? I was like, you're paying me to help educate you. So I had to sit there and like it was for computer science. And he's just like, the program needs to do this. And then he just sat there. And then I would kind of like try to ask him questions and point him in the right direction. And he wasn't having that. Just some douchey little kid who thought he could just pay money to have his homework done. But yeah, teach him how learning works. That was the idea. Didn't tutor him anymore. What a turd. Yeah, he's a bit of a turd. Bit of a turd. Oh, that's right. I think these cars crash and then it runs into one of them. Boosh. Oh, yeah. You gotta make the sound effects when they're not there. Was it one-on-one? Yeah. It was, private tutoring sessions. There was one kid that I tutored who was super sweet. We would meet in this, like, Target cafe, and it kind of breaks my heart to think about, but I just don't think she ever really heard much encouragement. So it was one of those things where, like, I would see her do problems step by step, and then she'd get to the next problem and then stare at it and immediately be like, oh, I don't know how to do this. And then I'd have to be like, you just did this. Like, you can do it. And, what? I think that's all she needed to hear from someone, from anyone. Just some voice other than her own mind reassuring her that she actually had those abilities. And sometimes that's all it took. And it made me feel real bummed that, like, that didn't happen in school. There was also, I did notice another problem when I started tutoring high school students is that they would be doing, like, levels of math well beyond where their understanding was. And it's one of those, like, the system should have caught that you don't know the basics yet. And that's not their fault, really, but it was pretty apparent that a lot of the times students are just passed along instead of held or given the right instruction. I guess sometimes you can lay that at teachers' feet, but teachers have a lot of shit they gotta deal with too, so. It's unreasonable to expect that a teacher is going to, like, provide that encouragement to, you know, every one of the 35 students in, like, when I went to school, or when I went to, like, public school in Texas, my classes were about 30 to 35 students, and there were 8 periods a day. So imagine you're a teacher who has to work with, God, let's just run the math real quick. Let's say 35. Imagine you have to work with 280 students. How are you gonna know what in, like, you don't even have the time to individually know them all in their learning styles. They at least teach evolution there. Not that I recall, not in school. I was pretty heavily pushed by church, but no. No, the creepiest stuff that happened was really just, like, revisionist history. That was kind of pushed. the treatment of the Civil War and all that stuff was pretty glossed over. Also, zero sexual education, but that's to be expected, I guess. So yeah, I don't know. When teachers have to account for that many students and are held personally responsible for their like state mandated test results, and they have to like buy their own goddamn supplies and stuff, I can understand how the system turned out like it is. But it was just really disappointing, and yeah, disappointing is the right word, I guess. To see kids like they're not bad or stupid. They missed a step somewhere, and everybody else kept marching. And since they missed that step, they missed all the ones following it, and were either too afraid to ask, or teachers didn't have enough time to like really bring them up to speed. So, yeah, it was sad. The system sure does leave people behind, despite what Hillary may have said about it. And it's not like things are getting better either. I feel so bad. I have a friend that's a teacher. She has a protected social media account, so she can actually vent sometimes. And hearing about the shit she has to go through, not only to raise her kids, but to also teach remotely, is just banana pants. Here we go, there's that sick music. To see that happen, and to see the extra burden that has been thrown upon public teachers in the United States because of all this, and then to have people be like, it's my right to not wear a mask. You just really don't give a shit. You really don't care about the consequences of your actions, or you refuse to acknowledge them, I don't know. But I think about my friend and how she hasn't had a break in 9 months. A single break. It's either working or trying to teach her kids, or dealing with all the extra work and prep that comes from teaching remotely, trying to grade stuff remotely. Actually, take that back. She did have a night where she got to have a margarita and some fajitas. And I was like, man, I wish I could do something to give you more margarita nights. Yeah. A lot of remote teaching problems are related to budget. Yeah. It was crazy because, like, the state did provide something. Like, it gave her a giant jug of hand sanitizer. But it didn't have a pump top on it. It was just the jug. And she's like, what am I supposed to do with this? Just a big industrial jug of hand sanny. Yeah, Captain, that's that. Believe me, I'm going to do that. But it's more like where I'm at right now. And I've tried to bear this out through various philanthropy. But like, I'm doing okay financially. And what is money for if not turning it into like turning it into things that help you or the people you like? So I was trying to be like, hey, can I throw money at you and create more free time? And she's like, no, not really. There's just no way. So that's more my frustration, is like, I would like to provide direct assistance. I mean, I did buy like everything I could off of her Amazon list, which, hey, if you wanna hear an awesome thing, teachers have to put their supplies in Amazon lists and hopefully people will buy them for them, because the state does not. Cool stuff. Although that's been happening for decades. My mom was a teacher, and I do remember when we would go school supply shopping, we would buy my school supplies and also the supplies she needed for her class. We did it. For the first time ever, Coruscant has been destroyed. Yeah, it's too real. Yeah, sorry. I dip into to. Ooh, wait. Ruins. Oh, I'm back on Abu, huh? The Gungan Sacred Palace. Ah, remember the part in episode one where they had to go to the Gungan Sacred Palace? Erkett, thank you for the sub. Can't wait until they outsource education to Twitch and Ninja teaches my kids world history. That'd be sick. I'd be pretty good at teaching world history. Better than Ninja, probably. Retro Future, thank you for the sub. Scored in 3080, shipping in October. Dude! Black Mage, nice. Currently have an AMD Vega 56, ray tracing cyberpunk incoming. I'm happy for you. RDR911, thank you for the prime. I think I got everybody. Windexter, thank you for the sub. Oh, no, I missed some. Never mind. Evermurf, thank you for the sub. In addition to the gifts, I appreciate that again. Beral, thank you for the prime. King Egg, good to see you again. I haven't seen that new Rubber Bandits video yet. I should do that. Oh, thank you, Cyclog. Yeah, sorry about that. Too many feels from a guy known as Whack Gamer. My bad. My bad. It's, oh, yeah, the sound effects are just gone, huh? I will try and... I did save. I absolutely saved. You watched the new Night City Wire? Yeah. Actually, I watched it with Steph this morning. Damn it! I watched it with Steph this morning. Can you pick any? No, you... Okay. You have to... it's pretty cool. Pretty cool. Glad to see and learn more stuff about that game. Ooh, Beardy Boy. Thanks for the sub. There's still no sound effects. Well, it looks like I have to reboot my Dreamcast, so just hold tight for a second while I reboot that. Oh, thank God. That is not a... Thank God that's not a, a bad meme. Don't look at this. Don't look. Don't look. There's no reason to look at this. What? App data? What are you doing? Ugh. Don't look. This is just... Nope. Wrong. Don't look! This is just a, what am I... Don't look. Don't look yet. Don't look. Nope. Wrong one. Don't look. I don't understand what that other core is for. Don't look. Nope. Don't look. Don't look at my files. My Dreamcast files. Don't look. No looking, please. There. Don't look. There we go. Just a normal Dreamcast. We've all seen it a million times. We've all seen what the Dreamcast looks like, so there's no need to comment on it, because we all know. Ooh. Hey, what's up, Camtron? You know what? I'm gonna go there. I'm gonna go there. Steph was trawling the internet looking for reactions to Night City Wire, and my God, this is a take that I wanted to throw out on Twitter, but I've learned that that's not the wisest thing lately. However, here's the spicy take I reserved, because I think when you say it out loud, people don't react to it as negatively as possible. I get that the gangs look a little stereotypical, right? That's what happens when it's a sizzle reel. But holy shit, man, the people who jump right to the most aggressive conclusions they can possibly jump to is exhausting. It's funny. It's like Puddlegate, you know? This is... The gamers used to get hyper mad about puddles looking different. Now there's another crew that gets hyper mad about anything they presume to be not fully socially just. And my God, man, they gotta fucking back off. There's a lot of assumptions going on about CD Projekt and their treatment of the source material. Also, just a ton of, like, that shit came from Cyberpunk. Like, that, a lot of that stuff wasn't created by CDPR. It was created by Pondsmith, a black man. And like, CDPR took that and made a world based off of it. And part of that is it inherits a lot from that world, but they also, like, they updated a lot of it. So there's been some interesting back and forth there. Yeah, there's a lot of... It's funny because I think it's a similar thought process, which is, here's this great new thing. And the gamers look at it and they're like, oh, I'll be able to go third person. I'll be able to wall run. I'll be able to customize my car. Like, they assume all these things. Although wall running was shown. I can't sneeze at that, but... they assume all these technical features that will be in the game, and then they get really mad when they're not. Or they look at a pre-demo and they see all these technical features, like, oh, it's gonna have reflections, it's gonna have particle effects. And then the end game doesn't have them or doesn't have them to the same degree, they get really mad. The idiot who thinks the Animals Gang is racist because it had some black members? That happened, but there's a new wave today. So Night City Wire showed, like, all the, basically touched on all the gangs, and some of them do read a little stereotypical in that sizzle, I have to admit. When it, like, shows the tiger claws, and it's somebody speaking in a very Asian accent, you're like, my God, tigers, Asians, okay. Me as a white dude, that's where my head goes. But I think CDPR has shown enough to prove that they're treating those subjects as completely and thoroughly as they can. There's a crew out there that cannot wait. To dogpile on CDPR for being not woke enough. And I'm just like, God, what? Ah, can you just wait? Can you just wait for a second? Granted, disclosure / humble brag again. there is someone in this household that works there. So, and also I'm really excited for the game. So I'm naturally a little defensive of it, for both reasons. But the man, to have people like see this and then accuse CDPR of being in like a cultural bubble or like call it high school level writing, which is some of the stuff I've seen. I'm just like, holy moly, holy cow. It's just a new version of the way that I hate to keep calling it like this, but like the gamers or whatever, the way that they will be so condescending and dismissive of like some technical or content things. Man, it same process, same shit. Which is not trying to make a both sides argument, but I do think it's this: you project into mental space, or you just all you want is the dunk. Like you just want your 2 points, and you're gonna take the dunk without thinking about it, because if you thought about it, you might lose the opportunity for the dunk, and you can't wait for it. Yeah, way to be. I am very smart, or like I've got moral high ground over this thing that everyone likes. So yeah, what's frustrating is like the people who are claiming that stuff are just like dead wrong, dead wrong. Some people being annoyed they couldn't join the gangs. I guess that makes sense, but I thought they addressed that pretty well in The Wire. As you can see, like, well, you're a mercenary and you have your own group, but I guess that makes sense. And I think that's one of those things where like in a game like Cyberpunk, you want to know that you can do absolutely everything. I gotta admit too, this did occur to me. I'm a little sore about that right now too, because I got some tasty dunks on me because of me mouthing off about Demon's Souls not being a PS5 launch title. Which is like, in context, it makes sense, because they didn't say it would be, so why would I assume it would be? But then people are like, look at this asshole saying Demon's Souls isn't a launch title. I'm like, come on, dude, like, contextually, doesn't it make sense that I would think that? Doesn't matter. No one's there for context. People just want the dunk. People want to make fun of a stupid person. That's just the way it is. Whether or not you are a stupid person doesn't matter. Yeah, if you just watched the event, you wouldn't have known. That was the idea. Like, it was based off of my reaction to the event itself. But people treat it as some kind of ridiculous oversight that I didn't see the future or immediately see Jeff Keighley's Twitter. It's weird, man. But that's the thing, like, you can never push back on that stuff. You're just not allowed to. There is no recourse. If you make an understandable mistake and people dunk on you for it or whatever, that's just what they get to do. Why did they put a heal there that's outside the bounds of the map? I can't get it. I want it. Yeah, context is almost always ignored, even before social media. You're right. Yeah. It's nothing new, and to some degree, it's naive to expect that from people, so that's just the state of the world. Just, man, it's exhausting sometimes. Have everyone treat you like an idiot, even though, like, it's obvious that people are choosing to treat you like an idiot. They're choosing to believe the worst, even when information is there to not. In any given possible situation, there will always be at least one person saying something negative. Fair bet. Fair bet. Astute observation. Yeah, you have to accept the dunking or you come across as triggered, for sure, yeah. It's win-win, really. Is that it? Hold on. Oh, I guess that is it, okay. Ugh. Yeah, they win or they win even more. Yeah. And that... It's one of those galling things where the only winning move is not to play, but you really want to win. You're like, right. Like, I need that person to know how stupid they are, but they're going to refuse to acknowledge that no matter what. So it's like, your victory condition doesn't matter. the Dark Souls roll. Oh! Ah, well. Night Ranger, or Night Range 16. Thank you for the sub. You love Phantom Menace? I'm growing more and more fond of it as the years go by. I really am. If I try to make them feel stupid, am I the stupid one now? Kinda, yeah. It's truly just trying to embrace the fact that some people aren't there for any kind of constructive dialogue. They're just not there for that. And no matter how much you try to push them into that, they're still not going to accept it. They just won't. It's a powerful thing to just say, I don't care. Like, I win. That's the wild thing, man, and some of the people that I kind of get into it on with people on Twitter for sport sometimes. But there are people who just straight up, like, go back to 8-year-old. Is this gonna kill me? No. They go back to, like, just 8th grade kind of argumentative tactics of just being like, I win. Like, I've actually talked with people who straight up say, I win. They, like, declare their victory. And I'm like, holy crap, dude! Are you actually... You might actually be 12. I'm just gonna try to get past this, bro. Don't need you in my life. Yeah, that's a real power move, actually. I believe in any academic debate, if you say I win, you automatically win. So clearly they are trained. So tired of the lack of nuance in people's arguments. Everything comes off as super negative and it's exhausting. Yeah, RJ, dude, one of the things that I'm increasingly, like, I was always aware of it, but I'm growing increasingly convinced of it. If you speak to any group that's big enough, that will always be the dynamic. That's just human nature. So the secret is to just not care about the mass conversation, the marketplace of ideas. Just find a community that you care about and can discuss things intelligently with. Some people would say that's a bubble, but that's people forming groups. It's just how it is. It's how people underestimate how many young people and old people are on the internet. We always just assume it's other people our age, yeah. If somebody's engaging with you, you just assume they're like mindsets, like cultures. Even like tone. I've definitely fallen victim to like assuming that people are coming at me with way more aggressive tones than they actually are. Which is bad, because if you answer something that somebody intended with a neutral tone in a negative tone, then they'll trend negative and it just kinda goes downhill. So one way or the other, you always have to be the bigger person to prevent that cycle from starting in the first place, which is also challenging and exhausting to do. Because, yeah, it means that people get to fire an opening salvo at you. Sometimes they're not. Sometimes that can just be how it feels. But it means that you have to be like, well, what did you mean by this? Basically, all the time. Yeah. Gotta assume positive intent, but the trolls, yeah. The problem is there are people who consciously, actively, take advantage of that. They have entire, like, conversational flowcharts to waste your time and frustrate you if you're actually trying to engage with them positively. Luckily, those people are usually so stupid that they use the same phrases. My favorite is, I'm just asking a question. Like, when somebody says that, you're like, okay, you're not just asking a question. It's like, you gotta stop giving it away that quickly. Questions with loaded intent, it's like, you made it obvious, right off the top. There's a couple of phrases that have become huge red flags, because for the people who just want to argue, it turns out they don't really come up with a lot of their own phrases. They're just there to sort of carry out the game plan they've been given, so that they can feel smart because somebody said that this is how they own somebody on Reddit or some shit. It's so wild. Oh, sea lioning? Yeah. Yeah. Barging into conversations. What the hell is that? Yeah. What are some of the phrases? I mean, I'm just asking questions. I'm genuinely curious is the exact phrase when you know somebody's actually being a little asshole. There we go. Got him. Had to use the shield, but got that stupid bug. When somebody says, I'm genuinely curious, they're not. They're absolutely not. I see that one used a lot. I'm like, you're not. I think there's a graphical problem going on here. That should be water, right? Or swamp water? I guess it is? I don't know why it's so striped. Yeah, someone's gotta mow the water. Give it that baseball diamond pattern. I kind of tweeted about it a while ago, but like, one of the big ones I've seen lately is you're smarter than this. That condescending bullshit. Using your name a lot is another one. Lawrence, you're smarter than this. Maybe I'm not. Shut up. Here are the facts is a fun one. Let's be clear. Like, those are politician phrases, which is fun. Politicians use them a lot. And then pundits use them a lot. And then people who listen to pundits a lot start using them. So there's some you can kind of tell sometimes through the phrase, the like verbiage and diction that people use, where they've been. Hey, do people use that creepy as name thing? Oh, like they just drop your name in a conversation? Like the point, typically the rhetorical tactic of that is to remind somebody of who they are, you know? Using somebody's name is pretty charged. And the only times that I try to do it is when I'm like trying to remind somebody that they're a person and I'm a person and we're people talking to each other. Because it can be easy to lose that sometimes when you're super charged about a topic. Oh, fuck me! All right, it's shield time. I'm not messing with you. So if somebody's just getting really vicious and like and making a ton of like charged personal statements, that's when I'll be like, you know, Brian, dude, what's going on? But a lot of other people use it as like condescending and diminutive, maybe to remind you of how your parents talk to you or something, or to make it seem like it's like there's a manager who has to talk to you. Thank you, spirits. I'm genuinely curious. Are you smarter than this? Am I smarter than a fifth grader? Managed to grab any City Pop off the re-release site that I linked some days ago? I mean, there were tons of artists I didn't know about. I'm going to use that more as a reading list than buying vinyl. Oop! Well, there it goes. There's a lot of like classic City Pop that I'm not educated on. I gotta admit though, I am much more of a fan of the modern takes of City Pop, your Young Bays and your Macross, god damn it, and your Macross 8299s. Like, the actual original City Pop has some bops, but it is a little too close to like easy listening for my usual tastes. Like, I finally listened to Plastic Love, which was really interesting because it is just sort of a mishmash of a bunch of American pop music kind of seen back through the lens of Japanese 80s tech boom culture, which is really fascinating. There's like a lot of, there's like some 50s doo-wop in there, plenty of like 80s easy listening. Damn it. Oh! Oh no! Midichlorians! Save me! Obi-Wan! Oh! Camera! Shit! Ooh. The bugs shoved me off of a cliff. I'm a Jedi, goddammit. That's what happens when you don't have the high ground. Alright, I'm up here now. Huh. I don't have any more shields. Fuck, these little guys. Ow! There we go. Yeah, they spawn infinitely. They jump? Fuck! Stop it! Stop! Shit! Goddamn! Okay, I can mind trick them. Maybe more won't spawn. I can't imagine doing this on PlayStation. Oh! Oh! So many bugs! Oh. Uh-oh. Oh no. Ah. Fuck! Stop it! I can't move! Stop it! Go on, Turbo! Alright, shield time. I had one shield. Checkpoint. Oh, fuck me. Alright. Stop it! God, Naboo sucks. Stop! I have to go to the Goongan ruins for some reason. Maybe. Oh, wait. Is that the. Wait, is that the set piece in episode one where they have to plead for the Gungans to help them?
This I like!
What am I. I gotta fight. No! Why do I. No! You're gonna make me stab these guys? I guess I did that in the episode one game too. Luckily they don't run. Oh, I gotta murder them all. What's up, Man Mountain? Welcome. I'm here for the Star Wars and promise to not talk any shit. Do you ever talk shit? I feel like I haven't known you to be a shit talker. Yeah. Peace! Life will never be as simple as it was when Boss Nass held up the peace orb and proclaimed peace to the world. That was the last time we were innocent as a human species. Oh, they run away instead of dying, okay. The track record of our civilization is Boss Nass with a peace orb, and then 9/11 happened, and it was all downhill since then.
Peace.
Yeah, Ansem, I've been... Given how horrific 2020 is on every possible level, I've been thinking a lot about the pre-9/11 days. The post-racial illusion of the 90s. It was a nice illusion. Oh, we got a big boy! Ooh! Yeah, now they run off, yeah. Oh! Why? What? Did I, like, hit a button to, like, walk only or something? What is going on? I... Okay, now I can run. Weird. Ooh! Fuck me! This boss fight is pretty wild. Come down here, asshole. Mind tricked! Oh, he's dead. Oh, he's fine. Mind trick! God. What? Oh! What? Oh! There's Scooble Scabs! What are those called? Oh! Are you just gonna throw those at me now? Just taking a little nap. Alright. They're Gomdarks or something. Fuck it, finally. I was worried that we were just gonna button mash at each other and he was gonna kill me, and I'm like, well, I got no strats for this. What? What? I wanted the. I mean, I know it's not that scene, but come on. You know, the waterfalls on Naboo? They did that practically in Port Salt? Yeah! That is so cool! Ugh. I feel like culturally we're all realizing maybe we're a little harsh. No, we weren't. Episode 1's not a good movie, but... Why does she look... She looks like depressed. Okay, I guess we're in a Star War. Mass murder has always been the Jedi's bag? No. They only kill when they have to. Only when they have to. Gungans are racist? No, they're not. Representation is good. Oh. Oh! Oh! Look at this gameplay! Sick! Peace! After this, let's go to Taco Bell and get our 1999 Star Wars commemorative cups. The worst thing that's ever happened in this world is Tiananmen Square, or the Timothy McVeigh bombing or something. I don't understand how life could get any worse than it is. This part of episode one was pretty sick. Oh, you can just hold the button down, even better. Oklahoma City bombing was your birthday? Ah, shit, Sino. I'm sorry to hear that. Ugh. Turns out Antifa's been around for a while, huh? Okay, that was a bad joke. I shouldn't say that stuff, lest it seem like I'm inviting discussion. One of my birthdays? Oh, yeah. You've had more since then, and I'm glad to hear. Oh! Okay. There's no health bar. So I gotta just figure this out. Water was anti-Semitic characterization of a shop owner. What about it was anti-Semitic? It may have leaned into, like, Jewish stereotypes, but I don't know that it was anti-Semitic. I do admit, though, his little helmet does look like a yarmulke. And he does have the, like, little... He does have the little hair doodles coming down. Yeah, he wore a kipper hat. For sure. Oh, not a yarmulke, kipper. Yeah. I am... Clearly not, not culturally savvy enough to even have this discussion, so... What? Am I hitting something? They portrayed him as a greedy cheat. I guess that's a good point. I always viewed that more as like, I viewed that more as a product of his environment and his character than his nature. I guess, but I see what you mean though. Yeah, that's a good point. I don't know. Hey, Wada was all right by the end, you know? Honey? He's just a small business owner trying to make his way. That's all. So many lasers. Holy crap. This game absolutely needed a turbo tunnel sequence, and I'm glad that it's here. Oh! Not a Star Wars game unless you're doing a trench run of some kind. Yeah. Feed will never recover. Eat it. Holy crap, you have to start all the way over? Really? You have to take the ramps or you blow up. You have to. And if you miss them, you die. Cool. He did own child slaves, that's true. You know what's weird? There's a lot of people who kind of wanted to see the seedy underbelly of Star Wars or whatever. Rogue One kind of did a good job of showing that. But Episode One had some pretty gnarly shit in it. It was just wrapped in a Star Wars container. Yeah, sure, it's child slavery, but it's fun! Yay! Wizards! This is so loud. God. Yeah, death sticks. You wanna buy some death sticks? I actually really like that line. I do wish that you got to see more of the Coruscant Cantina, though. Because, yeah, when Episode 2 opened and I was like, oh, baby, here we go. Like, we're going to see some fucking Star Wars nightlife. And then, yeah, it's just that one asshole dude. And then Obi-Wan can't have a drink in a bar without chopping off somebody's arm. I don't like you either. Good shit, man. Alright. Try and stay near the sides. Yeah, also, yeah, the whole Jedi rig out is a little questionable, a little sus too. They go and they basically snatch up kids and train them. I guess it makes sense. It's kind of like X-Men in that way. An untrained Force adept could go Sith or kill people accidentally or something. So it's one of those, like, control for the sake of safety. I did it. I think Jedi are selfish lovers. No. I would say, like, most of their training is about sacrificing self or subverting self for the needs of the many. So I would theorize that Jedi are probably, to their own detriment, non-selfish lovers. I think Jedi are the ones that, like, they meditate while they're boning out, so they can go for, like, 10 hours, but it's a very unspirited 10 hours because they're not into it. Oh, Jedi, totally fuck. They're just not allowed to form connections. Obi-Wan spread his seed a little bit. Jedi know where the clit is, but they only stimulate it very robotically. There's no dance with a Jedi. It's just like, I will apply stimulation now. Stimulation complete. Yeah, Obi-Wan got his bone down. Oh! Climb the cliffs to reach the palace. Rescue at least 5 pilots before time runs out. Oh! What? All right. Yes. This is a interesting level. How do we make this game harder? Time limits. Good idea, Stan. Jesus! This is not helping my world record time here. Damn it. Oh. Dead. Dead. Who's that random guy in the picture below? Those are the pilots, I guess. 5 of which I have to save. Imagine you're about to get ruddy with a Jedi, and they make jokes about lightsabers extending, and you're like, ugh. God, I'm trying so hard to be horny, and you are really working against me right now. What do you want from me, game? Would a Jedi need a condom, or could they force pull the nut out? I think they could force pull the nut. I mean, they could also probably force choke their own dick so that when they come, it just stays inside. That'd probably hurt a lot, but whatever. Oh, they Jedi mind trick the sperm. That's a totally good idea. Yeah. If you just put them all to sleep. What's up, Six-Son? If you force jerk yourself off, is it still bad? No, I mean, much like Christian doctrine, I'm gonna assume that, oh, there's a ramp over there. The ancient Jedi texts probably just don't touch the idea of masturbation at all. And masturbation, like, doesn't involve forming emotional connections, so I'm sure it's sanctioned, if not even encouraged. Where the hell are these pilots, man? Are they all bunched up right at the end? This game can also do a really annoying task of, like, hiding jumps and stuff off of camera frame. So I'm worried that that's going to be the case for a lot of these stupid-ass pilots. They're just on little platforms hiding off in the middle of nowhere. And if you don't know that they're there, you'll never find them. Great, well, came all the way up here for a life. Still no pilots, though. 0 pilots. Are the midichlorians and Jedi come? I mean, it's in blood, right? So that implies that it's also in saliva. Or pee, maybe? Do you think if Anakin, the most powerful Jedi, peed in Padme's mouth, that she would become force sensitive? Because I submit she might. And he probably did, so. That's how Leia Organa was so strong. Leia and Anakin, or sorry, Leia and Luke, were so strong because of all the pee that Padme drank. Couldn't get enough. Where the hell, man? Need to find. Maybe if you find one pilot, it gives you more time. Gross. Hey, take it up with George Lucas, all right? I'm just here trying to play a video game. That's not my problem that he wrote that. That's his problem. Oh shit, the door's open. Fuck. Oh, is that a pilot? Arrgh. Oh, I just killed him. Is he dead? No, he's not. He just moved a little bit. Okay. I can't believe there's another version of this game that has the same audio bug. Whatever audio engine they used must have... Okay, I'm still not getting... Oh. Must have, like, a memory leak or something. Can I save your dumbass yet? There we go. Like, tap... Timer? You had better tack something on there. Oh, no. Oh, maybe it's... Maybe there's one in each of these rooms. Oh, bruh. No way. God damn it. Like, reflecting lasers is the only... What the... If they don't shoot lasers at me, it takes forever to kill them. They block. Shoot a laser at... Shit. This is the real duel to face right here. There. Holy crap. What? Can't... Oh, okay. Alright. You don't have to... It didn't... Oh, no. Okay. So I've got to pick up the power-ups as soon as I go in, or it won't let me get them. Alright. 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 That's how we're gonna do this. And, like, this fucking animation takes a long time? Also, there's four doors. Which is... Oh, are these green boys? No, they're not. Okay. Fuck. They have so much health. Fine. Fine. Beat my ass. Just do it. Do it. God damn it. God damn it. I'm back here. I'm back here. What's the door in the earlier part? Okay. Well, now I know what they look like, so... Hopefully I can find them. Maybe there's, like, more than five pilots? You just have to rescue five? Yeah, maybe... Wait, I don't know if this door counts. Let's find out. Nope. Okay, there's a door. Maybe this one counts? Nope. I'm gonna go this... Wait, I think I went this way last time? I can't remember. Let's check it out. What's over here? Oh. Drastic. Thanks for gifting a couple of subs. Get this first. That's a pretty good combo right there. Speaking of, like, just mashing out the same three hits over and over again, I'm actually pretty excited for Hyrule Warriors. Maybe I should go back and try the Switch re-release. It's been a long time since I played a good chonkity Musou game. I'm getting the itch. Okay, there's just multiple rooms. Whoa. Okay, all right. I get it now. There's more than five rooms. I guess the idea is you have to pick the ones that have the fastest enemies to kill. Yeah, I've always loved Dynasty Warriors, but, like, for me, Hyrule Warriors just felt really mechanically flat. It just, I don't know. I didn't see the like, potential of it for some reason. Maybe I gotta go back and check it out. God, stop fucking blocking! There. Hyrule Warriors have canon lore? No. The first one does not. The second one will, which is kind of, oh shit, which is kind of interesting. Yeah, the new one is solidly in canon, which has me even more excited for it. Makes me hope that maybe they're working on like cutscenes and maybe a little more features to flesh it out a little bit. I guess that's what it was. Hyrule Warriors felt like, I know that every Warriors game is a reskin like lol, but Hyrule Warriors felt like an even less mechanically interesting Musou. Guys, trying the spicy McNuggets yet? No! And I've, like, ordered from McDonald's a couple times. Every time I almost get a spicy nugget, I'm just like, but the originals are so good. I don't want to risk it. I should just get both. Kind of goes against my policy of no waste, but why not, man? This is why the terrorists hate us, because we can get both kinds of nuggets. They hate us because we're free. And freedom means I can order two kinds of nuggets from McDonald's if I want to. And I understand also I was talking about dieting earlier, so I've only fallen into the McDonald's trap a few times when I kind of had the calories to do it. I try to make sure that no matter what, excuse me, no matter what, I don't go over 2,000 a day, which is maybe my maintenance. Maybe it's less than that now that I'm just sitting all day and not really moving around, but yeah, everyone needs a cheat day. You're right, Ansem. I'm afraid to like introduce a cheat day because I know that I won't be responsible with it, and I can find ways to load myself up with calories. I think it's conceivable, especially if I have some drinks, that in one day I could really throw off any kind of calorie progress I've made through the week. Spicy's just okay, but better than regular, not better than Wendy's. Wendy's probably has the best nugget for my... Actually, Jack in the Box nuggets are real solid. Real solid nug from Jack. I know that, what is it? Kinda Funny just did their Nug Dome. I guess they decided that McDonald's spicy nugs were the winner. Pretty cool. Chick-fil-A? Yeah, Chick-fil-A nugs are the closest to actual food. And I do love the seasoning they use. Sick! Medium pizza, chicken sandwich, some fried chicken, some tacos, etc. All that in one day. Yeah. I feel like if I ate bad food and drank, I could probably put down 4,000 to 5,000 calories in a day without thinking about it, really. And if I'm doing 1,500, which rough estimates is like 500 calories under a day, I'm pretty confident I can erase all of my calorie gains. There he is! Except the sound messed up again. Got hair in my eye. This is it, you guys. Got the RP walk. Oh! No! Bullshit! He didn't do the thing where he ignites one side and then the other side! Fuck off! Why did I buy this game? I'm going this way. There's secrets over here. Yeah, see? Told you. I actually feel like I really want audio. I really do. I feel like... Oh! Wait. You can just live in the best part of Duel of the Fates, which is the beginning. Cora. What are they even saying? Is it Latin? Cora. I never even looked that up. Here we go. Cora mata. Cora ratama. Wow, it actually doesn't... Does it... It's Welsh? Yeah? That's an interesting language to use. It's good. Welsh. Oh, these words originate in the medieval Welsh poem Cad Goderu, The Battle of the Trees. Huh. Under the tongue root, a fight most dread, and another raging behind in the head. Huh. Williams had translated into a variety of languages, eventually selecting Sanskrit because of the quality of the vowels. If we read between the lines, then John Williams liked Sanskrit because it helped provide that ritualistic or quasi-religious character that was missing from the other languages, and no doubt English in particular. Yeah, to me, it just sounds so much like Latin cheering in like Beethoven or something like that. Duel of the Trees, yeah. John, it was a great sword fight at the end of the film. The decision to make that choral was just the result of my thinking that it should have a ritualistic or quasi-religious feeling. And the introduction of a chorus might be just the thing. The medium of chorus and orchestra would give us a sense that we're in a big temple. Yeah? Or that it's a cataclysmic biblical fight between two like religious forces, which is what it was. It's very cool thinking back on... and this is something that I'm pissed off because I think I came to this... I came to this realization while watching episode one, and it gave me chills. And then later in a roundtable, I think it was it Filoni that talked about how Duel of the Fates was it's a literal title because it's talking about who what happens with Anakin, and if the Force is meant to be the representation of determinism or fate in the Star Wars reality, then it is essentially the Force fighting itself to determine what happens with Anakin. And interestingly, what happened was kind of a draw. Qui-Gon didn't live. Darth Maul didn't live. Obi-Wan got him. And kind of... That meant that Anakin wasn't hard light or hard shadow. He was in the middle. And waffled between the two. So, which is kind of a weasel, really. But is a really cool way to set up the writing of the prequels. Again, like, going back, there's so many great ideas in there. And it's just a bummer that it's kind of all laid out really haphazardly. All right, let's, one second. Don't worry about that. That's just a normal Dreamcast wallpaper. Don't worry about that. There's a history. What am I? Don't worry about any of that. Don't worry. Poorly executed good ideas, yeah. What game is that? That was BioShock. That was back for, like, I saved that when they were putting out promotional screenshots for the game a million years ago. 2008, I think, so. God, these cutouts are so sick. We can have real photos and games, man! Alright, guys, it might be time. We might actually close the book on Jedi Power Battles here. It's always 420 in Margaritaville. There's also a really interesting video by Matt Colville, where he talks about how when Qui-Gon messes with the dice with Watto, he tempts the fates by essentially defying the gods. I mean, sort of. If he's channeling the Force to change the dice, then that must mean that the Force wanted it to happen, right? Because I know it's all scattershot, and sometimes applying like logic to it as a cohesion doesn't work. But I really go back to that scene with Chirrut. Like, the Force abandoned him the second he did what the Force needed him to do. So if the Force really didn't want Anakin to leave that planet, the Force would have not allowed Qui-Gon to move the dice. You have to kind of lean back into the Force, like our Lord works in mysterious ways at some point. Am I missing something? Or if Epic wins against Apple, what happens to Sony, Microsoft, and Nintendo? I'll take 30% cut and doesn't allow sideloading. Oh, I don't know. I gotta admit, I should, just because of my love for technology, but I haven't really been following that little slap fight very much. Oh, Sixon, thank you for gifting a sub. Bring it on, Maul. Ooh, he's tough. Ooh, he's tough. Ooh. Holy crap. Ow. All right, we're gonna go. Nope. I guess I gotta hit him enough until the next sequence triggers. I need to... Holy crap. Liss up, thank you for the prime. Boy, he's dealing me an ass whooping, yeah. Ooh. Okay. Oh, do I get to see this cutscene every time? Maybe if I get him on the walk up. Nope. Woo! Okay, I can't finish that combo. That is not safe. Okay. Hopefully there's health. Oh, he's coming for it. Oh! Well, he wants my ass bad. Okay, so if I run away from him, I just wait for him to do an attack and then I can punish. Except he'll randomly block sometimes. Like, ooh, okay. Well, okay. According to the EU, that's probably scrapped now. Everything went the way it was supposed to anyway. Anakin becoming Darth Vader, giving the Empire the edge, ultimately saved them when there were invaders from a different galaxy that were immune to the Force and technology they had developed were the only things that worked against them. Oh, really, Relic? That's an interesting idea. There was like another, like, Borg surrogate, unstoppable technological horror, something like that. That's a cool idea, actually. That overhead seemed good to come in with, but maybe not. It's very punishable, so. God. Maybe I just try to hit him with this triple combo and then run away? He blocks it every time, though. Jeez. The Yuuza Vong? Oh boy. Thank you, Clutch Crew. Maybe if I hold block, I can escape some of this shit. Do something. Thank you. No, he breaks my guard instantly. Fuck! And then he... Like, I wake up into attacks. He's meatying my ass. Shit! Holy crap, dude! Okay. Isalamiri were lizard-like tree dwellers, about 50 centimeters in length, native to the planet Mirkur, most known for their ability to repel force by creating force-neutral bubble. Alright. Cool. Yeah, good old Darth Maul is working me. Oh! What? Huh. Oh! What? What? When did I get the ability to do this? I mean, he's just gonna block everything. Okay, I guess I can turn into smoke. Cool. I like how it's a trade. The best hit I can get is a trade. Oh, that's not so bad. We gotta just see. Wait until I get some distance and then use this lunge attack. Maybe that's safe. It's not. That wasn't really a lunge attack. Fuck! Ooh. Where's his health bar? He doesn't have one. You just have to bash him until he goes to the next phase. Maybe I just try to button mash on him, see if I can outlast him. I don't think that's gonna work, but... Like, if he blocks you, he gets a free hit on you. Sometimes. He doesn't always take it, but he gets it. Jesus! Like, I'm holding the stick, and it's just all hit stun. I can't do anything. Man, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know that I have tool. I don't know that I have the right kind of tools to deal with this guy. Oh no! Oh, I thought the music cut. That was weird. Fuck! God! All right, new plan. Maybe I can get the running X off and then this might work. Dude! I couldn't move for that whole thing. Okay, make sure that he's chasing me. Then try the X. Nope, he just blocks it and then murders me. All right, that is not remotely safe. Man. Igni works best against Anakin. If only I had Igni. Alright. Ooh! Right into it. Like, I need his block stun to be long enough to let me get out, but it's not. And I don't think it gets longer for anything. Yep. Why did you make me do this again? Like, it just kicked me back to the menu, so I just go right back. Lives are important. It's even beatable. It probably is breakfast cereal. I just have to find... I have to find the loophole. I have to find the animation that's like, reliably dodgeable and punishable. What? The second I hit B to jump, the exact frame that I did that, he did a stupid little explosion and knocked me out of the air. So he like. Some amount of button reading here. Maybe if I get this stab off. The stab seems like it has the most range, so if I land it at the right distance. It seems like it's safer. So if I can get enough of these hits off on him, I have to wait for him to do something, which I don't like. Because he might just hit me. Like that. No! You're pretty good. I got lucky there. Nope. Ooh. Ah! Like the character will auto turn and attack if I'm close enough. And it kind of hard to tell if I'm ever close enough. All right. Well, I woke up into that. Great. He's gonna kill me now. Oh wow! Let me go. Shit. Ah! I think he can just grab me. He can grab me with that even when I'm running from him. So I have to... Ah, man. Shit, dude. This is rough. Plays like they expect you to spend coins. Yeah. This game have a lock-on and a dodge. It does have a lock-on, but the lock-on's pretty useless. I don't remember what button it is. There is a way to do it, though. There it is. Yeah, right trigger. You have to hit right trigger. I don't know about dodge. Oh, yeah, okay, there's a dodge. I played the whole game without using these mechanics at all. I guess I'll try and experiment with that, but I don't... Like, the dodge is slower than just moving without lock-on. Carlito Supreme, thanks for gifting a sub. Hey, look at that. Look at that paying forward there. Don't forget force powers. I only have two. And one of them, he's immune to one of them. I can turn invisible, but then he blocks absolutely everything. He blocks all of it. And I don't think, like, he can just block forever. And then he can murder me as soon as that. There's also the mind trick, but he's immune to it, so, you know. You're not invincible while you're dodging. Yeah, the dodge doesn't have invincibility frames, semi-coherent. 100% true. I wasn't able to move that whole sequence. Couldn't do a thing. He took half my life bar and I had no inputs at all. We're gonna get very familiar with this song. Holy shit. He has 7 phases. Are you serious? Do you get health through any of them? I don't remember if you do. Maybe there's a combo that'll work. Maybe a combo will work. Any of them. Also, why did it reset the count? You can't. Is that? That's the combo? I guess it is. Alright. I guess you can just rattle out the combos and they come out? I don't know. Yeah, imagine playing this as a kid. Yeah, that giant pause is just in the combo. Alright. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Holy shit, man. He, like, started blocking in the middle of a combo. He just decided I didn't get to hit him anymore. Remember there being a Y controller where you rolled a bunch with a ton of small hits? With this character? YYYYYA. I don't understand why some of them are lit up and some of them are grayed out. Is that the roll, maybe? YYA. Yeah, he's just that good. Play as Obi? Maybe you have to win as Obi? Oh. I don't give that much credit to this game. Yeah, I need a combo that just has a really quick hit on the end of it so I can get away. Like, I need a combo that ends with super fast recovery. And ending, like, YYA seems pretty good for that. Fuck, man! It's like, the more I drilled into, like, having safe combos, the more of an asshole he's becoming about popping me when I'm just running around. He can just stun lock you, dude. How's this house? Thanks for the prime. That one wasn't so bad. That combo's a little bit better. Fuck, man. Also, like... Yeah, that jump is not safe. Fuck! X6AA sounds cool. Sure, let's try it out. It's got that little chop at the end. I think the kick takes too long. Maybe not. Yeah, he starts hitting me after the kick. The XXX combo is like the fastest. Maybe it's just XX is all I can get away with. No force abilities. None of those. Yeah, all of the force abilities do not work. Maybe I just try like one hit. One X. L plus A? What is that? That's not an ability. Unless you meant... Well, I guess I'm going off of Xbox controls. The one on the right does this, and it absolutely does not work. He stops attacking me, but he just blocks everything. So there's really nothing to be gained there. If I could find a way to reliably hit him with that lunging attack. But, like, he won't reliably attack. And sometimes he can just nail me out of a run, if he just chooses to. And then, like, if he blocks, he gets a whole follow-up on me that's at least half my life. I still can't move. There we go. I got out. And now he kills me. So, like... If I could safely bait out attacks, this would be different, but... Nothing I've seen so far has let me see that I can do that. And then he just does that shit. And then he gets a wake-up attack on me. Oh. He was in an attack animation and he still guarded out of it. I was like, I'll take to the skies. You can't attack in the air though. Just jump back by pressing the run button and back while in lock-on mode. And immediately begin the combo again. You hit maul, wait until your combo's finished and start it up again. Jump back, pressing the run button. There is no run button. I don't know what that means. And your back dodge is not invincible. So, like, you can't back dodge out of combos. I'll try it. Maybe this will work. Nope. Google says to use Mace Windu. I have to play the entire game again. That's unfortunately not an option. Maul continues to take your controller, grip it in southpaw mode, and slam through your monitor. Just boosh. That combo worked pretty well. That one time. Do not see a combo work once and think that it's reliable. Yeah, see, he can hit you out of the back. Also, if he gets me into a corner, what then? Ugh. Use Mace Windu. I can't. I'd have to play the entire game again. Does he break your guard in one combo? Yes. Absolutely. I don't know about this lock on. Sick combo though. Oh. Obi-Wan says mash X and you can hit him. They say Adi is the second hardest to beat the game with. Great. Who's the hardest? Is it Blow? It is Blow? Awesome. Because he's slow as fuck. Yeah, I don't know about this. If I can, like, get it, if I could. Ugh! Shit. If I could bait. If I could just reliably bait out attacks. And then it's pain. Fuck. Shit. It's like his fucking Killer Instinct combo breaker. What the fuck, man? He just explodes in red anytime I'm about to hit him. I don't know that I played a game with a broken last boss fight like this in a long time. Oh my god. Tried running to the right. It looks like you're not blocked off. You absolutely cannot run to the right. That's where he runs after you hit him enough. Believe me, I tried running away as much as I could. See. Maybe I can get him caught on geometry or something. What's that beep? What? One walkthrough said use Game Shark codes. Yeah, this might not be doable. This might just be so broken that it's not possible. I guess I have. I'm guessing there are Jedi Power Battle super fans. Man, this would be such. I don't want this, man. It took me. I had to buy this game, play it on different systems, play through it multiple times, only to get to a boss that is unbeatable. That's what a walkthrough said about the boss. Like, it's mechanically not doable. How underwhelming would that be? Like, if I can get him to do that jump. I'll see if. It doesn't seem like you can reliably bait out attacks. Also, he can still just hit you. If you're in a full sprint, he can still get you. That is not safe either. Maybe I was turning too tightly, so let me just try a big ol' circle and see if he'll just randomly decide to do his jumping attack. It seems like that's the only thing I can get a real safe hit in on when he lands. So maybe I just gotta be really patient and wait for that one. Maybe that's it. Maybe that's the whole thing. Not punish any- yeah, he can still just grab me if I turn too tightly. So 90 degrees only. Yeah, he can just hit you. He can just choose to hit you, and then he does. Maybe I gotta do more of an oval so there's no hard corners. Oh! But he starts like cutting in to me and like making it shorter. Fuck. I keep getting tricked because I think he's jumping and then he's not. Maybe there's multiple animations that are punishable. I'll have to start testing them one by one. Do figure eights and unlock the secret door? Man, I wish. I wish there were a secret door to the end of the game. Great. Sick. Shit, man. Damn it! I don't think I landed a hit on him yet. I'm like, all levels, she go and beat him with Obi-Wan? Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I might, yeah. At this point, I feel like cheat codes might be necessary. He's just not doing any attacks. Like, if you never get close enough to him for him to hit you, he never attacks. And the second you do, he attacks and hits you. It's like if you start turning the angles a little tighter, he'll do attacks, but some of them just hit you. They're not, it's not safe ever. Hit him a decent amount after back dodging. I don't recall that happening. You might be referring to the one 3-hit combo I got in on him, but staying in on him and back dodging is seriously just not feasible. It's just absolutely not. Damn it. Back dodge, like, calling it a dodge is deceptive. It's just slower movement. He still hits you out of it. So there's zero mechanical reason to do it. Shit. Great. Okay. So I gotta cut the corners so he doesn't attack, and then I just pray it's not one that hits me. Duh. I'll just decide to do that, I guess. Bird Kizzle the Legend, thanks for the Prime sub. If I can get the stab attack, then usually I'm far enough away if I space it right that I can't actually have that be blocked and have it be safe. But then also sometimes the attack just doesn't come out and then I run into him and he kills me. Yeah. That was starting to pay off a little bit. A very little bit. Whew. You beat this with audio and like Kadu races? What? I don't even know what that means. You should have a ranged force power to use. I do not. But, defense, long range, is left trigger and A. It doesn't do anything, but maybe, yeah, maybe I've got to be close. Maybe I have to be next to him. Yeah, it doesn't do anything. That's actually not a force power at all. It's just not in the game. One of the two guides I said, Maul can be really easy or really hard, depends on who you are. You can just run around in circles until time runs out, but you won't get points for hitting him. Oh, so it is timed. That doesn't feel right. You might be that might be the Tatooine level. The Tatooine level times out, and you don't get points for not hitting him. This doesn't time out. At least it doesn't feel like it does, because I've run in circles for a very long time. So yeah, make sure you're not looking at the Tatooine Darth Maul fight, because that is absolutely run from his ass until the ship takes off. Crap. Fuck. God, timing this sucks. And aiming it blows. Oi. I just wish he would do longer attack animations every time. And that I wouldn't have to aim them. Fuck. Fuck me. Why did you not attack? Shit! Thanks for the miss. I got very lucky there. What? Ah. It's Phantom A button. Great. Dark Souls has mechanic. This is not Souls. This is just a broken game. It actually says everything chat has been repeating. What's that? The only thing that I've really heard is that you just have to use cheat codes. Everything else I've seen has been attempted and debunked. Or maybe I didn't do it right. Yeah, playing as a new character does require starting a new game. Levels are unlocked per character. Hey, Redline, thanks for the Prime sub. If I could reliably get distance from him, maybe that's what I gotta do. Just like, let the attack animation play. Hopefully I get some distance from him and then can hit him with the lunge on the run-in. But you don't always get the lunge unless you're running for a while. So if you stop moving, you lose it. It's gotta be like that. And then it doesn't always hit if he's off fucking camera. Holy shit. You cannot do more than running away and stabbing or playing perfectly, yeah. Clem, thank you for the resub. Want that code again? I didn't see it the first time, so I don't know what code you're referring to. Lock on right before a lunge. You can't do that, because if you lock on, you stop running. And you only do the thrust if you're running for a long time. So if I did that and then A, I just do that attack. Which actually may not be so bad. I'll try that. As a way to instantly face. Maybe that'll be a way to do really quick punishes. Please. The issue remains, if he blocks, I can't get away. Can't get away without... And then sometimes he also just hits me. Also, I think if he's off screen, the lock-on doesn't grab him. Lock on and use L plus A for force power. It doesn't exist. It's not there. She doesn't have it. It doesn't do anything. I swear. Great. I did it. I don't understand how there's not, like, there's not, health anywhere. Do not use any of Adi's force powers except the long-range one. The others have no effect. And only use the L2 plus X one if you need to. I don't understand. Long-range left trigger plus A. Did you bind the keys right? Well, I mean, like... Yes. How could I use any other force power if I'm not binding it correctly? Left trigger, B. All right. Left trigger, A. What is A? Let's see. A is vertical attack. Maybe I didn't bind it right. Maybe I haven't been using a button this whole time. Maybe that's the case. So vertical attack, high attack. Yeah, those are different buttons. What the hell was that? The midichlorians are upset. What the f- Alright, houses. Thanks for gifting out the, gifting some subs there. Yeah. Maul's blaster. Like, that works. The only power she has, yeah, is left trigger Y and B. A's just not a thing. I don't know why. I mean, A is working as select in all of the menus, but left trigger A does nothing. So I don't know. I don't know. There's no honor in beating a broken game. There's tons of honor in beating a broken game, though. I don't know, it's... This is one of those things where all I have to do is find the one thing that works. And once I find it, then I'm set. God, he gets one hit on you and you lose half your health just because of his relentless comboing and the fucking absurd hit stun. Oh. Maybe if I just make him walk into a triple X combo over and over again. But the problem is when he gets in on me like this. Like, when he does this, I pretty much have no option. Nothing is safe when he's right next to me like that. God! That might work. Yeah, it's really just like, if he starts blocking you and he's too close, he just nails you. It's extremely risky, and Adi will get hit multiple times during the fight. Due to Adi's great speed, you'll be able to land a few hits on Darth Maul before he backs away or you get hit. That's it. Alright. Yeah, I guess that's something then. Yeah, he can just go right from a block to nailing you with a super long attack string. If you're too close. That one's way too close. Alright, that attack moves me forward, which makes it bad. All the attacks make you walk forward. Which is horrible. Like, that means I'm closer to him when he's done attacking. Or when he's done blocking me, and then goes directly into tapping me to death. Use the horizontal things, they seem to work better. Sort of. Everything works equally well because nothing works. The horizontal swings are better because they move me forward less and are faster. But like, okay, I gotta, like, yeah, I can't do multiple hits into his guard. If I do that, then I'm definitely going to take a hit. Because it moves me forward, which I hate. But, like, that means I only get one hit on him? If that, like, I have to do multiple hits because I don't know if the first one's going to land or not. You just have to be mathematical with spacing, and you don't really have time to, like, confirm if the first hit is a guard or not. So you have to at least do two. Fuck. That is a little more reliable, though. But I, like... if there's not health after this phase, it's... okay, I gotta just do the two hits. Just the two. That might work. Oh, there's less room here, though. Is it possible to jump over him? I would... then he'd just turn around and hit me, like a... I don't know that really gains me anything. Oh, what? Code for unlimited health? Let me experiment with this a little bit. See if I can... if I can get past the second phase and there's health, then maybe we got a stew. Maybe we got a stew going. Damn it. Fuck. Okay, that was a pretty good first run. Pretty good first round. Fuck, let me move! Let me move! I hate how you're at the edge of the screen. Shit. Can you go back into the first area? You can. Okay, I'll just drag him back here then. Ah, bruh! God damn it! Now he's just blocking everything. He just decided I don't get to hit him anymore. Fuck! Alright, well, I'll keep experimenting. Yeah, well, thank you. If I give this a couple of cracks, and it's still just wildly unpredictable and unsafe, then yeah, I'll just use the cheat code. Because this, like... yeah, that's the biggest problem, Likeable Lime. is that there just simply aren't any safe attacks. Shit, man! Fuck. God, sometimes I get that run attack instead of the triple X combo too, which is worse. So I gotta remember to like let go of the stick right before tapping X. Fuck! Like, he just has to choose to let you get away. Yeah, there's not a pattern. There's no reliable AI. This reminds me of like Mortal Kombat AI. Of like the quarter eating input reading shit. Where you just have to cheese it. You have to find the cheese. Yeah, that's true. He hasn't done the red power ring in a while. That's a good point. Quarter health lost, still can't move. All right. And we're away. Maybe if I run there, I can get a combo on him. Nope, dead. I wanna keep trying until I at least get past the second phase and see what's after that. If there's a full health and I can more reliably judge the distance, this might be more possible. We'll see. Yeah, you can't. When he's on you, you can't just tap his guard. He will punish you every time. Fuck. And like when he's off screen, I don't know what he's doing. Clearly, it's like I just have to kind of guess. Yeah, Cream. This fight's bad. I think he's faster than me too. Great. Ooh. Oh. God. I got one hit out of all that. Fuck, into the corner, bad! Do something. Okay, well, could be better.
Oh.
Do something that doesn't hit me, please. 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 Ooh, okay, phase three. If there's no health in here, then I give up immediately. Oh, there's a tiny health. Is there a checkpoint? That'd be something. Oh boy, an item. Platforming. You have to beat two of his phases and then do platforming? Ugh. Oh, come on. Ugh. And no checkpoint. Don't make me fight him on a bridge with a pit on both sides. Oh, checkpoint. Oh fuck, I have 5 lives, alright. Oh, okay. Okay, health. Okay, now the lives matter a little more. Oh wait, there's a can down there. I have no idea what it would be good for. Amp, great. Does that do more damage, maybe? Another checkpoint, weird. See him tip-tapping towards me? Didn't even let me finish the combo. Dude! Fuck. Oh, okay. MarioFoe14, thanks for the Prime sub. Do something, please. Do something more than that, please. Do your little jump. I love that jump. Shit. Fuck. I knew that was gonna grab me eventually. Alright. Sound effects are starting to go. Fuck, it's actually not that bad. Kind of prefer it this way. Oh, of course, yeah, he can't fall off. God, no. Fuck you! Oh my god. Holy shit. Fuck, man! I just have to, like, pray. I gotta hit him and pray. Oh! More health, maybe? Yeah. Ugh. Come on. What is that? Okay, good. I don't want to pick up question marks. Another checkpoint. This is... What? This is such a narrow platform. Oh my gosh. I hate it. I'm gonna have to jump over him. Maybe he just does force lightning now or whatever? He does not seem to be moving. Maybe this is the pattern where I can just bash his ass to death? Seems to be working. I think he's trying to run to the next transition already, but I keep grabbing him. Yeah, all right. Oh, nope, never mind. Wait, what? Are there save states in the simulator? There are. If I get down to 1 life, I think I will drop a save state. There's fucking droids? You serious? Yeah, I was... I was, that could go either way. Like, if he has different attack patterns on another phase, they could be easier, they could also be harder. So, and also I have shields now. Maybe that'll do something. Health? Oh, I have full health, so. I'm scared that I missed it, but I also didn't need it. Alright, another checkpoint. Sick. It's all downhill hill from here, guys. Oh! God damn it. Got flipped by a fucking robot. Alright. Now we got some sick platforming. Fucking lasers aren't synchronized. Good. I'm glad you're dead. Oh! Why would they make you do this boss fight and then platforming? Instant death platforming. God damn it. And like make you jump towards the camera. It's just like horrific design. Ugh. It didn't knock me off the platform, so that's something. Oh. Yeah, Crash Bandicoot is just... It's a hard game, but it's all... Like, Crash Bandicoot 1, at least, is mechanically busted in a lot of ways. That game sucks. I tried playing the, I never played Crash Bandicoot as a kid, so I tried playing the remake trilogy. I was like, man, Crash Bandicoot 1 is busted. That game is not good. 2 and 3 are probably better, but... Oh? Oh, I stopped the fan. Ooh. I'm so annoyed that this is also a level, on top of being a broken boss fight. That is not fair. Don't do- oh, a life. Careful. Analog control. Good. Okay, so there's a life in this checkpoint, at least, as long as I don't die before it. It just ate the input. Just didn't let me jump. That robot wanted to die. Alright. He's like, he's stunned, but he can also guard. Man, I feel like nothing says Jedi Power Battles more than a droid who, after attempting to bash you with his gun, is stunned but still guards your attacks. I'm gonna go back and get that health. That's probably not a good idea. Let me pick up this life first. Okay. Yeah, whatever. Just keep going. Okay. Jump. Hip. There we go. Another sweet checkpoint. Sweet, sweet checkpoint. Ah, God. This game is terrifying. If there were a checkpoint with 2 lives in it, that would be amazing, because then I could just farm up a million lives and feel a little more secure. But I don't think that's happened in this game, unfortunately. Oh, I lost all my items and stuff. I'm surprised, shocked even, that didn't kill me, just dropping that distance. Oh no, there's enemies that way. Hold on. I want to grab the checkpoint first. There. I was worried that, like... Which way does the level go? Dude. Why is he blocking everything? Jesus Christ. Oh, I guess the level is this way. That's just points. No, I have to really use the restroom. Okay, I gotta use the restroom. This is very tense, but I'll be right back. Nope. There we go. Alright. That's right, I'm going back this way because it seems like the level was the other way. This really feels like the level's this way, though. I'm guessing there's just a power-up room over here. What is going on? Where's the level going? Oh. No one-ups or anything. Gamer P go well? Pretty well. It was one of those, like, it was pretty built up, so there was a lot of force behind it, and then I felt some of the splashies hit my shins. And then that's always a rough call. I was like, well, do I wipe my shins off, or do I just live with it? I'll let you decide what I did. I took a shower? Yeah, exactly. I'm curious how... Why does it turn green? I'm curious how Darth Maul's gonna react to the shield item. What? Blue... Do I just have to, like, step on certain panels to make force fields change? Looks like going to each corner? No? There was an order, maybe? Maybe. Hey man, anything's possible at this point. Oh yeah, red may mean wrong. So red. Blue. This was green, right? Let's try red. No. Okay, there's green. Let's try bottom left. Light blue. Oh, back to green. Want a minute. Jesus Christ. Light blue, all right. This is like the most blunt, inelegant maze. Yellow. At least it lets you go back a step instead of restarting the whole thing. That is uncommonly light blue. That's not good. Oh, green. Shit. Shit. I have to go bottom right for light blue, I think. What a shit game. Yeah. Oh, wait. Light blue. So wait a minute. Oh, maybe I have to go up here. Light blue. Green. Damn it. I don't want green. Alright, light blue is top right. Yep. Like there's... I'm gonna go see... Okay, yellow. Good. Purple. Mm-hmm. Huzzah! Checkpoint. Ugh. This game is exhausting. Alright. More super sweet platforming. Luckily these are just all the same jump, so it's a little easy to make. Oh good. Man. Fuck! If you hit the double jump without holding a direction, you jump straight up and you have no control. You just die instantly. I don't remember what quick save is. Just save state? I mean, I got one more life, but hold on a minute. It's one of the F keys. F5, okay. I'll run it right up to my last life. Oh, good. Wait, did I ever just try mashing X? Maybe I didn't. I can't. Oh, it doesn't work. Never mind. Oh, okay. Shit! I think he's going. Yep. I like how we stopped to do a stupid little explosion. Is there health in this room? Oh. There's force, thank you. Ugh! And a random item. How utterly chill of them to put a random power-up in the last room. I'll just mash and pray. Odds are low, but I'll try it. See if the force is with me. Oh, the wall's with me, that's for sure. Thanks, wall. Oh, you got me. Alright, we're gonna... Oop! Oh, fuck! Fuck me. What? What just fucking happened? Oh, thank God. Okay, so F5 is not... save state. Default button to save a state is F5. That opens this. God damn. I'll try F6. Oh, what is that? No! No! Stop it! Stop! Fuck me! Full screen. It's not even fucking full screen. Save slot 0. Did it overwrite? I don't. Loading state. Wait. F1. Save. Okay, is it F2? It's F2. Okay, fuck me. God. How do I get it to go back full screen? Because if I just alt enter, that doesn't work. Ugh. Fuck, no. I want you to go full screen! Why do developers not use universal controls? Save slot 0 means save. No, it does not. No, it doesn't. That's just choosing the slot you're going to save in. There. Fuck. Me. Okay. RetroArch gotta be different. Yeah, let's what if we rewrite our entire UI? Nice meme. Alright, I'm just gonna bash at him until I win the battle. Sorry, that was a lot of panic there. I hit F5 and it refreshed my Twitch monitor. I was like, nothing happened. And since this is yeah, I thought the game crashed too. I wanted to save my breath before I lost my damn mind. Ow. Yeah, frustratingly, you actually don't have to land that many hits on him for him to go to the next phase. That might be different in this. Like, if this is actually the last encounter, you might have to beat him up a fair amount to kill him. Here comes that wall again. This is the real Duel of the Fates right here. Ow. Thanks, wall. Let me go get that random power up and see if it's health. Yeah! The force has decided. Oh! Oh! Ooh! Technically, I didn't use a save state, so... Technically. Although, really, I think at the end of that, it justified that I could have probably just mashed X on it the whole time. And just prayed to get past the first two fights. First try. Show me those credits, you son of a bitch. Controller! Gimme that orb! Gimme that orb! Gimme that orb! Where's your orb?!
You have done defeating this Sith Lord. Difficult it was, but never only one Sith can there be. Always two there are.
Beers! No less. Dude!
And an apprentice? Destroyed one you have, but one yet lives. Celebrate your victory. But forget not.
Shit ain't right.
Conflicts remain.
Hawaii! Oh, hold on. They biffed it, man.
Oh, wait a second. I'm busy.
Peace! Come on! Actually, I really want to eat this now. Play the clip. You're right. Why is there no music? There it is. That's what we came to see. That's what we're here for. Oh. I think it's 4x3. It's so grainy. Oh. Hand of the orb. I wish this glowed. Oh wait, hold on. There we go. Oh, Jar Jar's being fun. Oh, Jar Jar. What was that fucking orb? It's the pizza orb! Give him the orb! Yes. The orb of... Come on, do it. Hold the orb aloft! The orb rises! So, gotta watch that framing. The movie's not over until the orb ascends. Peace! Thank you, Carlos Patriot. What did you do exactly, Carlos Patriot? What... What creative input did you insert there that makes you think you deserve to put your name after the end of a movie that you uploaded to YouTube? Yeah, he uploaded. Oh, wait, hold on. What do you guys think? Do you guys think that the description says no copyright infringement intended? Do you think? Oh, 2007. Yeah, that was well before people were even aware of that. As requested. By whom? I mean, by everyone, really. Augie's Great Municipal... Oh, wait, that's... The name of the song is Augie's Great Municipal Band? Oh, yeah, I gotta watch that Nintendo Direct. Look at how big the font is for people working on this game. This is before there was 500 people. What a journey. What a journey. Read the comments. One second.
First, I got some trash to give away. Where is it? Where are you? Damn it. Where did I put it? Are you there? Is that you?
Nope.
Shit. Well, it's been so long I don't know where it is anymore. I was gonna give away my PlayStation copy of Jedi Power Battles, but I don't know where it is. Okay, well, if it's sometime in the future I come across it.
Ooh. I will, I will. Did you check the trash can? yeah, it might be in the trash can. Wait, Jeff Keighley? What? Did I miss? What? Who? What was his credit? Was Jeff Keighley really credited in this? I mean, the credits will roll around again, I guess. Oh, yeah. Bordabalint. Bordabalint? Yes. That seal is very adorable. He's very, very squishy. Oh, manual? Yeah, I guess he was a writer. He wrote the manual. Damn it! Now I want to find that game more than ever.
Maybe he only wrote the Dreamcast version, but I have it on PlayStation somewhere. God, where did I stick it? Maybe I put it... Oh, I know where it might be. Oh, wait, it's looping again. Great.
Why is it grayed out now? What's going on? Oh, I guess there's power save on Zimbo the Magnificent. All right. I have the PlayStation version of the game. I don't know if Mr. Keighley wrote that, but we can certainly dabble in his works. And I would be delighted to. Let's see here. I mean, make sure I don't miss it again. Oh, Ruth Bader just passed. Oh, that must have been what Stephanie wanted to tell me. Well, get ready for people to be dropping in chat saying that for the next hour, I guess. Hold on. Fuck, that means there's another Supreme Court Justice seat open. Let me see that name. Where is it? There it is. Jeffrey Keighley. Nice. Alright, let me see if I can go find... Let me see if I can go find a copy of, Yeah, Gonzo, that's really gross. Yeah, you're right, Doctor. In the short term, no one will care about our legacy. It'll just turn into the next political spat. I mean... Unfortunately for good cause, because... I mean... They haven't been shy about packing courts with their people. So, it's really scary and gross that they're going to get another Supreme Court appointee, and they're going to ram it through, because they already did. So, that fucking sucks. And this country is not going to recover from that for decades. Anyway, let me go find a manual. But yeah, that is very sad, and I have to go console Stephanie. So I'll be right back. Okay, bad news all around today, but I can't find my Jedi Power Battles PlayStation 1 game. Legitimately don't know where it went. I think at some point I had a fit of deciding that my desk was too crowded and packed it away somewhere. So unfortunately the expert writing of Jeffrey Keighley is not available to me right now, but I will find it. How could you lose that? Gonzo, you never lost anything in your life? Jeez. I like the concept that you make it sound absurd, out of this world, ridiculous, that somebody might misplace a jewel case. Impossible. All right, I gotta eat. Yeah. It is what it is in the U.S. We got to just press on. You guys got to vote. And maybe not. Maybe just fucking move out before this place becomes a utter hellhole. Maybe that. Maybe I'll take my tax money somewhere else. Maybe we should all do that. Anyway, thank you guys for watching so far. I will... Stream's not over. I've super modded Super Mario Sunshine. We got that 1440p resolution. We got that widescreen. We got that 60 FPS. The FPS is the big thing that I really want. So we got that buttery smooth Mario experience. I was tweaking Dolphin this morning and I got it working. So Super Mario Sunshine, happy game, happy vibes. Hopefully it'll kind of give us some still waters, pun intended, and all this mess going on. So see you guys in just a second. I got to eat though. I got to eat first because I haven't eaten since breakfast. So I'll be right back. See you guys in a second.